Hey, welcome back. We're doing more Free Talk Live here. You can join us on the phones at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And joining you in studio, you've got me, Ian.
And Johnson.
And Mark.
And don't forget to join us online. Just drop on by freetalklive.com. And of course, if you want to get involved with us on the air here, there's different ways to do it. One, the toll-free numbers, which I believe are working correctly tonight. 855-450-FREE is that toll-free number. And again, that's 855-450-3733. We also have Skype. You can Skype into the show here at username lrn.fm as we go to the story that I teased on last night's show, which we never got to. And then coming up, we will tell you about a I guess, Johnson, you've got an interesting story that was in my show prep. What did you bring in tonight?
Tonight, I brought in us talking about the swear words that we are not allowed to say on the radio, and apparently they're also not allowed to say in Arlington, Virginia.
Very disturbing attack on free speech, so we can talk about that. And so here's a story from munchies.vice.com. Should you be eating LSD for breakfast?
What?
Who'd have thought about that, huh? Put aside the over-easy egg, the lox and smear, and even the chia seed pudding. Or, yeah, whatever that is. If you want
pudding made of chia seeds.
Yes. LSD, Xanax, and Klonopin, breakfast of champions. Sorry, it's a line from Highlander.
That's if you believe in a small... Excuse me. If you want clarity and focus throughout your day, perhaps you should be eating powerful psychedelic drugs for breakfast.
This sounds like a really bad idea.
That's if you believe a small group of scientists and psychonauts who have increasingly sung the praises of what's called microdosing, or the ingestion of small amounts of LSD.
Oh, that's interesting.
A recent alternate feature by Philip Smith delves into the phenomenon, crediting psychedelic researcher Dr. James Fadiman for popularizing the practice in his 2011 book, The Psychedelic Explorer's Guide, Safe, Therapeutic, and Sacred Journeys. Microdosing, writes Smith, refers to taking extremely small doses of psychedelics, so small that the effects usually associated with such drugs are not evident or are sub-perceptual while going about one's daily activities.
So it's not evident and sub-perceptual. I think those words are the same.
It's being done by anyone from harried professionals.
Actually, sub-perceptual would probably be referring inward, and not evident would be more of an outward. So it's not evident to other people, and it's not perceivable by yourself.
Okay, so evident refers to evidence. I suppose somebody might be able to find evidence that the drugs, which are sub-perceptual, are actually working. Like, so for instance, just because you have taken the LSD, you know, you don't feel anything, some doctor might be, oh, yes, there's been a small dose of LSD administered if they take a blood test or something. So I suppose it can still be evident but not be perceptual.
Right.
So according to the story here, it is being done by everyone from harried professionals to extreme athletes to senior citizen businesswomen, and they're claiming serious benefits from it. A Hunter S. Thompson caliber ball-tripping dose of acid tends to fall in the 400 microgram realm, sending you into deep conversations with ancient platypus warrior spirits on planet Xenu. But Smith claims that a mere 10 to 15 micrograms can impart, quote, increased focus, emotional clarity, and creativity that your cup of cold brew can't. Bonus effect. You won't get screamed at by disembodied eyeballs in your glove compartment.
Yeah, that sounds good.
During a speech at the Horizons Perspectives on Psychedelics conference in New York City in 2011, Fadiman explained that with microdoses of LSD, quote, the rocks don't glow even a little bit. But what many people are reporting is, at the end of the day, they say, that was a really good day. You know, that kind of day when things kind of work. You're doing a task you normally couldn't stand for 2 hours, but you do it for three or four. You eat properly. Maybe you do one more set of reps. Just a good day.
Huh. Now, so what this brings to mind is that when you're talking about blotter acid, you can't really just sort of dose, you know, these micro doses like they're talking about. This isn't something that somebody could do on their own. They'd have to be part of a study, right?
Well, I'm not sure about that, Mark. I mean, it depends. I mean, if you know how many micrograms are in the blotter.
How would you know that?
Well, if you go on these underground marketplaces, they are marketed as claiming to have a certain amount. You would have to trust that person's assessment.
What a great idea.
and
trusting drug dealers.
I think we've already gone over the point multiple times here that these underground drug markets on the internet are fairly trustworthy. I mean, as far as
comparatively, but that you're comparing them to the black market where people die.
Yeah, no, generally they don't die from taking too much LSD.
I suppose you could compare it to the, you know, white market or whatever you want to call the regular legal market where people die.
Lots more of them die from prescription drugs every year than they do from non-prescription drugs. That's much true.
Look, I mean, I don't...
And prescription drugs are, as I've read, that are taken as prescribed by the people who to whom they are prescribed. Not just, you know, I got some prescription drugs, took them and died.
I don't know. I read a story that a lot of people really mess up their prescriptions, and that's primarily one of the causes of why people die from prescription drugs, because most people are really stupid about that in a scary, scary way. They're like, yeah, dose cup for the NyQuil. Yeah, I'll just take swigs. You know, like, how many Advil do I want to? Yeah, 4. What's, you know, when it's like the adult dose is 1. Yeah. You know, people do that stuff all the time, and it's like, guess what? You might be killing yourself or damaging yourself very badly every time you do that.
This is the problem with having, you know, non-experts administer drugs, right. And that's, you know, one of those things. You can't, prescriptions don't fix that,
right?
But people can't really drive, especially with the way, as many drugs as Americans are on, they can't really drive and every day and get them administered by an expert.
And then they start mixing and matching, so it's like, you know, who knows, you know, whether or not I can take this, you know, basically dextromethorphan kind of NyQuil situation with, you know, my antidepressant medication. I don't know. Eh, it can't be a problem. They're both over the counter whatever. You know?
You got to be careful with that stuff for sure. And some of it might send you into a crazy shooting rampage, apparently. The guy down in, the alleged shooter down in South Carolina, there's, you know, news stories now. He was on some kind of drug that was likely could have contributed to a bout of insanity. We can talk more about that if you want. You can dial us up here at 855-450-FREE. But as far as taking a microdose, Mark, if you were to get like a standard LSD dose is, I think from what I understand, like 100 to 125 or 150 micrograms.
Mm-hmm.
I'll have to review aeroid.org just to make sure I'm right about that. But if you were to get a 100 microgram dose, you know, you're talking about a very small little piece of paper for people who aren't familiar with the most common method of dosing LSD.
Smoked an ounce of LSD and then I injected some heroin or some marijuana. I'm trying to... I had a hard time. I couldn't mess up my drugs badly enough.
Smoking an ounce of LSD would be a really bad idea.
And then injecting 5 marijuanas.
It probably wouldn't work to smoke LSD because it tends to break down at high temperatures. So you generally want to store LSD in a cool, dark place.
You'd essentially be smoking paper at that point. Yeah,
pretty much. And so, anyway, if you were to get one of the little blotter pieces, you could then pretty easily cut that into 4, I think. And then if you cut that further, if you cut one of those fourths in a half, you'd have 12.5 micrograms there. So it's doable,
or
I would say.
It seems like maybe you could take that piece of blotter and put it into a bottle of liquid.
And then drink a certain percentage of it?
Yeah. Then divvy up the liquid.
Okay. Yeah, that might work too. I can't say I'm an expert at doing this, but I'm sure it's something that the average person can do. Smith spoke to a 65-year-old Bay Area woman who's been microdosing with psilocybin mushrooms rather than LSD for 35 years.
I don't even know if I trust her opinion.
She says, I just took a tiny sliver and found that it made me alert and energized all day. I wasn't high or anything. It was more like having a coffee buzz that lasted all day long.
No good, a coffee buzz.
Indeed, author James Orrick has suggested a secret affair between psychedelics and extreme sports, with athletes microdosing in an effort to increase their performance. Orrick rather breathlessly claims that, quote, LSD can increase your reflex time to lightning speed, improve your balance to the point of perfection, increase your concentration until you experience tunnel vision, and make you impervious to weakness or pain. I don't know about all those claims, but... It's an interesting idea.
Well, somebody had to take over for Leary.
With those kinds of gains...
I think we need to talk to someone who does this.
Who needs bulletproof coffee? A mere 15 micrograms of LSD spread on your blueberry coffee cake muffin might just be the best part of waking up. If you've got any experience, you want to share it with us here. 855-450-FREE. More coming up. It's Free Talk Live.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are and whatever you're doing. And right now, you can try Listen Clear absolutely risk-free with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. So call now, 1-800-940-5957. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your 100% risk-free home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now, 1-800-940-5957. That's 1-800-940-5957. 1-800-940-5957.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Hey, neighbor, what are you doing digging? You had a heart attack last year.
Oh, I know. I was told no more hard labor.
Then why are you digging?
Well, I've been taking Extendovite. It's been approved to help my heart.
Extendovite? Is that a new drug?
No, not a drug. It's more like an herbal combination made from garlic and cayenne.
Herbal? How can that help?
Well, actually, we've taken herbs for thousands of years, and Extendovite is doing the job for me.
Does your doctor know about Extendovite?
Yeah, my doctor knows, and he said it seems to be working for you, so don't stop taking it. I feel great taking Extendovite. I don't want to stop.
To order, call 1-877-928-8822. That's 1-877-928-8822. Or visit our website at heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it. Use it. Spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Join us toll-free. Bring up anything. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Speaking of LSD and underground markets, there's news about Open Bazaar. They're back in the news, in this case Fortune Magazine, reporting on what could be the next step in online distributed marketplaces. Now, I know Open Bazaar would prefer not to be mentioned in the same breath as drugs, but inevitably the technology behind it could certainly be used to sell pretty much any old thing that that you want to sell. So, of course, you can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. If you want to acquire Bitcoin, what I would recommend that you do is go to expresscoin.com Litecoin.com. They also have Litecoin and Dogecoin, and it is the best option to acquire cryptocurrency. In fact, you can even get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency for no transfer fee by using our code, which is FTL. So use code FTL, like Free Talk Live, over at ExpressCoin.com. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, by the way, you can use ExpressCoin.com. And when you're over at ExpressCoin.com, you can even download their app for your smartphones. They really do make it as easy as it can possibly be to get Bitcoin. So go and check them out at ExpressCoin.com. And don't forget code FTL. We were talking about the idea of microdosing LSD for breakfast. Apparently, there's a story, Vice.com has had it over at munchies.vice.com. I put a link up on our Facebook and Google, talking about how there apparently is some small movement of people that are taking 10 to 15 micrograms or relatively small doses of LSD. That's basically one-tenth of what is sort of considered an active dose of LSD. Obviously, 10 or 15 is still active LSD, but it's just not going to give you a psychedelic effect, essentially. It's going to affect you, but not in a lose yourself sort of way, or you know, you won't be losing touch with reality. Not that you would necessarily lose touch with reality at 100 micrograms, but nonetheless, it's an interesting concept. I know that I'm not a psychonaut or anything like that. And by the way, kids, not recommending that you do psychedelics. But if you are going to do psychedelics, I would recommend that you do your research first. And please go to arrowid.org, E-R-O-W-I-D. Great website. Arrowid's got all kinds of good information about lots of drugs, including prescription drugs, by the way. They've really got, you know, plants, drugs, all kinds of stuff there with lots of frequently asked questions and details. Oh, sorry about that, Mark. Try that again.
Lots of bad things can happen to you on drugs, right? Like, you know, you never know whether this is going to start as some kind of psychotic episode, or you're going to end up in a situation where you're hurt or you lose your life. These things happen on drugs.
Yeah, bad things can happen to you any day of the week.
Yep. If you have a bad thing happening to you, would you rather be impaired or not?
I don't know. It just all depends on what the bad thing is.
Well, I suppose that if you're going to die, and that you'd rather be impaired.
What they're saying here is that at the 10 to 15 microgram level, that you would not be impaired, that it would in fact enhance
abilities. This is somebody talking. Is there a study behind this, or is this just some people that claim that small amounts of LSD make you into Superman?
Well, I don't think anybody's making that claim.
Okay, what were the claims then? Could you list them off from the gentleman?
It is based on an alternate feature by Philip Smith, where he delves into the phenomenon. Apparently, there is a psychedelic researcher, Dr. James Fadiman, who popularized the practice, but I don't know if there has been necessarily
But he does make some claims. He makes a lot of claims.
No, it was actually a different guy, James Orrick, who is an author, and he claims that it can give you lightning speed reflexes, improve your balance, increase your concentration, and make you impervious to weakness or pain. I'm not sure if I necessarily agree with those claims.
Would you agree with any of them? You have no qualification to make
I've taken LSD more than a few times.
Yes, but you haven't taken micro doses on a daily basis.
Actually, I have taken half doses of LSD, which I don't know if you would consider a micro dose, but I have enjoyed a good Sunday afternoon. Back when I used to take Sundays off, and I don't anymore, but a good Sunday afternoon taking a half of a dose of LSD. And
when things don't melt, they just sparkle.
Does make things pretty, and it was wonderful.
Yeah, well, I just remember the time you took LSD and ended up in the psychiatric hospital.
Yeah, there was that time. That really had more to do with staying awake for several days than it did anything
What made
else.
You decide to stay awake several days?
I took LSD.
Probably the LSD.
Yeah.
Just saying, kids.
Hey, I learned
my
lesson.
You could lose your mind.
You can if you stay awake for
several
days.
I'm glad you found it again after they gave you the Klonopin, the antipsychotic.
Here's the thing, though. Like, with the LSD, like, LSD doesn't last for several days. So
that's correct.
How did you stay up for several days?
I simply stayed up.
Right.
Yeah. Anybody can do it. And you'll hallucinate harder and harder, basically, the longer that you go. I'm not recommending this, by the way. It was one of the most terrifying times.
Psychosis tends to present itself when? In the early to mid-20s.
Sure.
In males.
Is that right?
Yeah. That's when it tends to present, yes. Huh. Early to mid-20s, males.
I would think just about anybody who stayed up for 4 days would go into a psychotic
state. I would. But I wonder how it happens. probably could be brought on in some cases. I mean, there's certainly claims out there on the internet that it's brought on by psychedelics.
There's also claims on the internet that marijuana causes schizophrenia. So
there are claims.
I hate it that you blame the LSD for this, Mark. It was clearly sleep deprivation. We had an incident with another activist in the area who also stayed up for too long, and he went into a very similar state.
Well, he's psychotic.
And he did not take LSD.
There is an LSD-based reason for this, though.
He is not psychotic when he is regular, when he is not out of sleep.
LSD is a serotonin replacement in your brain, and so if your brain is prevented from absorbing the serotonin because you've got this serotonin replacement in your brain, you are actually physically incapable of sleeping while you're on LSD, you're at a full-blown high.
Anyone who's ever tried to sleep on LSD certainly knows this.
So, I mean, that could easily contribute to you not sleeping, at least for the first night.
Well, no, it wasn't that. It was that I didn't think time existed, and so therefore I didn't feel I needed to sleep anymore.
That couldn't be the LSD either.
No, that was definitely the LSD, Mark, as I've already told you. That led me to that conclusion, which, you know, is a conclusion that I can still understand why I came to. Because it is essentially a construct of man, but it is a useful one.
But so. the question becomes, though, like, what happened night two when you were no longer tripping? And
I don't know.
You only missed one night of sleep. And then on night two, you're like, I'm going to keep this rolling.
Well, here's what the conclusion I've come to. I've decided that over time, my business partner is a guy that does not value the state of his mind in any way, shape, or form. And I'm just going to benefit from the fact that when he's frothing at the mouth and taken away in a straitjacket, I get a nationally syndicated radio show that he's spent his entire lifetime building.
Let's go to Patrick. He's in Duluth.
He'll be like Roger Waters.
You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Patrick.
Hi. You could take prednisone as a derivative of LSD, and they prescribe that all the time. I mean, I go to my orthopedic surgeon. He gives.
Did you say prednisone?
Prednisone. Yeah, it's over the counter. People giving it to their dogs.
Prednisone is a steroid.
It is a steroid.
I know, but it's a LSD derivative. That's how they came up with it back in the 60s as a drug. And I actually go get a dosage. A 7-day pack, but I divide it out over a year. You take a small amount. You got tons of energy all day. You perform great. Your head keeps clear, and there's nothing wrong with it. I don't feel sore or stiff. You know, when you're older, it's great.
I am sore and stiff, I'll tell you that.
You put this over the counter. Your pain and stuff goes away. It's anti-inflammatory.
Patrick, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. This is Free Talk Live.
Now, a twice as nice twin kit special offer from Complete H2O Minerals for all GCN listeners. Get a Complete H2O Minerals twin kit with 33 different minerals, vitamins, and amino acids all in a liquid form. Enough for two people for 1 month. Regular price, $89.95. But now Complete H2O Minerals is offering the twin kit for $69.95. And all GCN listeners receive a bonus 16-ounce bottle of ionic silver absolutely free with free shipping. A $120 total value. Hurry, limited time offer. Call 803-794-4767 or click CompleteH2OMinerals.com.
Anytime, any place, anywhere. Radio remains the most intimate of all forms of media. At home, at work, in the car, on smartphones. Over 90% of consumers still listen to radio every week. That makes choosing radio as a place to advertise your business one of the best decisions you can make. Email advertise@gcnlive.com and partner up with an experienced GCN representative. Advertise@gcnlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective.
Hi, I'm Daryl W. Perry, and I need your help to give away my newest book. Yes, you heard that right. I want to give away my newest book, A Rebel's Journey. The book describes my path to the ideas of liberty, which began as a search for traditional values. I will only give away the book if I reach my fundraising goal of $2,500.
But wait, there's more!
If you donate, not only can you get the ebook and the audiobook for free, but you can get bonus audio content, including interviews with Jeffrey Tucker, Lynn Ulbricht, Ben Stone, Gardner Goldsmith, and Stephen Kinsella. Or you can get a signed copy of the paperback book and more. Your donation will serve to replace the profits I would have earned through a more traditional publication of the book. The funds raised will allow me to get the book into the hands of more people and to promote the book to a wider audience. To find out more about the book or to donate, visit arebelsjourney.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
This is the Onion Week in Review. A study published Friday by the University of Minnesota found that mosquitoes have no physiological reason for biting humans, with researchers noting that the insects feed exclusively on pollen and seemingly only suck human blood out of spite.
According to our findings, mosquitoes usually spit out the blood after a bite. They just really enjoy ruining outdoor activities and spreading deadly diseases.
Researchers added that mosquitoes often bite a variety of vertebrates besides humans, including baby pandas, koala bears, and very small puppies, all for fun. And in tech news, a new Visa talking credit card urges buyers to go for it.
Come on, buy it. You know you want it.
In other news, the utterance of a secret password grants customers access to a long-rumored 18-inch Subway sandwich. It's easy to tell what an area man would look like as a skeleton. And a longtime teacher retires without changing a single student's life. This week's scheduled interview with the surly and forlorn Matthew Modine was cut for time and is doomed to never be seen. For more, visit theonion.com/newsbeat.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
We are back with more Free Talk Live. Of course, you can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. We're talking about microdosing. I've got a little bit more detail here, actually, from rawstory.com on this. And it's sort of a phenomenon, a very small phenomenon. Of course, who knows how widely experienced this is. I'm sure most people who engage in microdosing probably don't talk about it too much publicly.
The first rule of microdosing? Yeah, you don't talk about microdosing.
But we will talk about it more coming up here in moments. Also, want to let you know about ProXPN. Now, if you're getting online, whether it's on your smartphone, your laptop, your work computer, at home, you should be protecting your privacy, and you've got to take the steps to do that. Your internet service provider is probably violating your privacy by saving your surfing history. They're probably keeping those logs for several years in some cases. And certainly criminals can try to sniff out your Wi-Fi packets. You can stop that stuff from happening by getting ProXPN. And you can get it right now for free for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, Linux. Go to proxpn.com/FTL. Download the software, get it rolling, and you'll be encrypted and protected from the prying and spying. Plus, you, when you upgrade to their premium account, will get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access. You can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites. Plus, ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits. You get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. Just go to proxpn.com/FTL and use code FTL50 to get 50% off of the regular monthly price when you buy an annual account with code FTL50. Breaks down to about $5 a month, and that's good for the lifetime of your account. So go to proxpn.com/FTL, and don't forget promo code FTL50 for a great discount on privacy that is priceless. By the way, ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits. Let's go to, we've got Mike in Oregon. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Mike.
Hey, folks. Hey, Ian. Sorry about yesterday. I called in to talk about police dash cams, and I was on the road, so I had to let you go because I was coming into an appointment. So what I wanted to talk about today was essentially recording police on the dash cam. So I'd like to set up a scenario and see what your thoughts are on this. So you got your dash cam going in your car, and the police pulls you over, and he notices that you have a dash cam running, okay? What is preventing this guy from, he asks you, shut the camera off for me. You say, no, it's for my safety. What's preventing him from taking out the baton, breaking the window, ripping you out of the car, ripping the dash cam off, smashing it, destroying it? Now
nothing.
There's no evidence.
Nothing at all.
My question is, what is, I don't see the benefit other than, the wiretapping law here to, incriminate yourself by saying, hey, you're being recorded right now. I mean, you're almost setting yourself up to be.
How would that be incriminating yourself?
I'm sorry?
How is saying you're being recorded incriminating yourself? I'm not clear on that.
Well, I guess they're going to look for a camera.
I shouldn't say incriminating myself, but admitting that you're kind of opening yourself up to a big problem as far as being violently, attacked.
Well, I mean, if the cops want to violently attack you, if you're dealing with a rogue cop who has a predilection towards violence, then, whether you're recording or not may or may not be the thing that sets him off in that way. Maybe he's going to get violent with you anyway because he doesn't like the way you look or how you backtalk to him or whatever.
At this point, I don't know of the dash cam that Bluetooths into your cell phone so that you can store it on the internet. That would be really awesome. Mm-hmm. But I would recommend that you have Bambuser, the app, set up on your smartphone so that you're ready for as a backup to a situation where some... but I suppose you're dealing with some kind of lunatic that might decide to smash your camera. I've dealt with a lot of cops, and none of them so far have gone after my dash cam.
Yeah, I mean, what you're talking about is an outlier kind of an experience.
Yeah.
It's very unlikely that that's going to happen. So I guess to better answer your question, the only thing that is protecting you from having that happen is, essentially pure chance that, hopefully you are not dealing with a rogue cop who is willing to take actions like that. I mean, that's a very scary situation, and there's very little that you can do if you have a cop who has a mind to hurt you. There really isn't much you can do in that situation at all.
Yeah. Well, I went and I ordered the Freedom. Well, it's not actually called the Freedom Cam. I actually did some research here on what type of camera this is, who makes it. It's actually called the Drive Proof Camera. And I actually went with, they have a second generation one, which is the DriveProof 210, and the DriveProof 210WH, which is the high definition. And they're actually both the same price. And I ended up going with the high definition one, and it should be here Tuesday. And I'm just eager to get this running and, see how it works.
I mean, it's always, whether we're talking about a dash cam or whether it's you just holding a video camera and recording, whether it's a cop that's dealing with you or a cop dealing with somebody else, there's always risk involved in this. I mean, I wouldn't want to paint any other picture besides the fact that you could get hurt, right? Whenever you're interacting with the police, there's the chance that one of them is going to, at the very least, put you in some sort of handcuff situation and, at worst, possibly beat you around when you're in those handcuffs. I mean, so things can go bad. They won't necessarily go the way you're thinking that they're going to go every time, and the more often you record the police, the closer you get to, encountering a situation that is not what you expected it to be. So I don't say those things to dissuade people from participating. I only say them to, be realistic about what can happen out there. In a place like Keene, New Hampshire, recording the police is a relatively safe activity. I mean, it's easy to get close to them with a camera. They don't get very nervous about you and your proximity and the fact that you have a camera. In other places where they may never have seen an activist holding a camera before, your mileage may vary. Now, again, that's not to say don't do it, but there are precautions you want to take, like Mark's suggestion. Have it streaming to the internet. That way you can tell them, I'm live streaming this to the internet.
Yeah.
And so maybe that will get through their head and they'll understand that if they smash the camera, then it's not going to stop the signal, at least the portion that had been recorded up into the smashing.
And I've seen some situations where not just dealing with police, but just general, kind of sketchy situations in life that a camera has been pretty useful.
Absolutely. Mike, yeah. Anything else you want to comment on?
Actually, something that you guys just mentioned a second ago, having this app called, I don't have a smartphone, but is it possible to take this DriveProof camera, which is essentially what you guys have, the Freedom Cam, is there something on there that will actually sync it to your smartphone to live stream this Bambuser? I mean,
Not that I know of.
Be awesome.
What's the question exactly?
Asking about some way to sync the dash cam to your phone.
Oh, okay, no.
Or somehow wirelessly do that. I maybe there is something like that out there. I mean, there are a bunch of dash cams out there in the marketplace now. So maybe somebody's developed that technology, but I haven't heard about it. Mike, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. That doesn't mean it doesn't exist, though. So we're
actually
doing some research.
This brings me to something that I thought of a couple days ago that I was thinking about writing an article for. So if you're a Liberty blogger and you want somebody to write an article for you, because I don't really have my own blog, but what the thought was is that I've always been bothered by the fact that if the police take your phone from you, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you have a passcode on your phone, you cannot legally be compelled to provide the passcode for your phone.
Can't they make you do it at the border?
No, I don't believe so. And even if they wanted to make you do it, you just say no. I mean, what are they going to do? Like, they can't force you. What are they going to?
I think they can.
We're
going to
hook you up to brain control technology. Sure, they can take your stuff, right. But then you just get it back later or whatever. However that works.
Easy.
I'm sure, it's not great. I'm sure it's not easy, but what I can say is that there is a different thing about that that's terrible, which is that they can legally compel you to put your finger to the phone if you have a fingerprint sensor reader.
Yeah, that's right.
Which is terrible. So what I've been thinking about is just I've been thinking of different ways. I have an iPhone, so the ways that I was thinking of is the iPhone has a single button press that is the fingerprint sensor. So what I was thinking is that if the police, you know, compel you to put your thumb to it, that you hold it down and then you say something to the phone to lock the phone, mm-hmm. right? And then, you know, turn it off or something like that so that they can't. Because if you turn off an iPhone and then turn it back on, it requires a passcode at that point. At which point you can say, nope, I'm not giving you that because I don't have to. I'm not legally compelled to. Well, I found a way to potentially lock your phone into Bamboozer in a way that they cannot turn off the phone and they cannot change what app is being used and without turning off the phone. And I would like to share that when we come back.
All right.
A method for locking your phone into a single app.
Stand by. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. It's Free Talk Live.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
Quantum Life! It's year 2523. There are colonies on Venus, Mars, and Mercury. People travel in bubbles, fly at hyperspeed, with brain implants and artificial gravity. A scientific genius and his clever assistant set out on an adventure through the solar system on a secret mission to find the key to access new frontiers and save liberty. QuantumVibe.com from Big Head Press.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618, blockitpocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
Want to listen to your favorite GCN hosts and programs without a radio signal or internet? Just call 605-562-4213. Get instant access to all GCN live feeds right on your phone, anywhere you want, anytime you want. 605-562-4213. It's our way of ensuring everyone has the opportunity to enjoy GCN. 605-562-4213. The future of talk radio. GCN.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the Liberty Media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you're invited to join us here toll-free, whether you want to talk about microdosing or recording the police, or recording the police while microdosing. 855-450-FREE.
Or recording the police microdosing.
That would be even more interesting. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. We've got Skype. You can Skype into the show. Username's lrn.fm. Johnson, you wanted to tell us about a solution that you've come up with.
Yes.
To keep the police out of your business if they, let's say, snatch your phone as you're recording them, because, you know, they might be rogue cops and they want to do something mean to you, or maybe get into your – maybe they think that because you're recording, they'll be able to get into your phone easily or something like that.
So my recommendation is if you're going to be recording the police, that you need to take a step before you do so. And that step is to enable guided access. You can look up how to do that. There's – you basically go into settings, and it's under accessibility if you're on an iPhone. Mm-hmm. And
so it's built into the system.
Yeah, it's built into the system. It's built right into the OS for iPhone users. And what guided access does is it allows you to set a separate passcode. So essentially, this is for sharing your phone. The whole purpose of guided access is so that you can lock down your phone if you had to share your phone with kids or, you know, a friend or something like that, and you only wanted them to have access to a few apps or one app on your phone. So the great thing about this is
so you select which apps to lock down.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And so, like, let's say you're going to be entering Bamboozer to be filming the police, and your phone could get snatched from you. Who knows? And, you know, your video might not upload, and you know, it'd be a bad situation. Well, with guided access on, if your phone gets taken from you, first of all, they can't compel your thumb or whatever to your phone, because you can turn off the touchpad. Mm-hmm. That's disabled by default. You have a totally different passcode, which you can't be compelled to give them. They can't power down your phone because the power button is disabled by default. There is a way to reset the phone, but if the phone is reset, then that requires a passcode, and so they can't compel that information out of you. So my tip is to absolutely, if you're going to be filming the police, turn on guided access and make sure you lock your phone into the camera app before you go ahead and do that.
Okay, now, wait a minute. So here's my important question, and that is that when you're in a situation with the police and you need to record, time is of the essence. You've got to be able to get to that recording function as quickly as possible. Now, when I was watching you do this, it looked like you were just punching a button a few times to turn this guided thing on.
Click. It's a triple click of the home button.
Is that the default thing, or did you set that as your way of access?
That's the default.
Okay.
And this is just for iPhones, is that right?
That's for iPhones.
So just to clarify, you start your Bamboozer, you start recording, and then triple click the home button.
Yeah, I guess you could.
The other way around.
Yeah, or the other. You have to start Bamboozer, and then you triple click to lock it into. Yeah.
Then start recording.
Yeah, sure. Or you can start recording, then triple click it. I think you can do it either way.
And that'll lock anybody else out who grabs the phone from you. Very smart.
It locks you into the app. Now, there is an app on Android called Sherlock. I kind of quickly just did some research on this. I basically looked up, you know, Android equivalent of guided access, and this app Sherlock, S U-R-E, L-O-C-K.
Okay. So we're not sure whether
I'm not
this
sure.
will actually
yeah,
work.
Exactly. So Sherlock supposedly mimics the features of guided access. And if it does work that right, and I'll let you Android explorers.
I imagine some of our listeners are on that case right now.
Yeah,
so definitely
tell me,
let us
know. Yeah, let us know. I mean, if that works, I just think that's a huge benefit, and especially bonus points if you have a fingerprint reader on your phone. If you have an Android phone with a fingerprint reader that can unlock the phone, if this app will allow you to lock into an app and also disable the fingerprint reader, because that's I think a huge part of this. That was my goal in sort of learning this. Is there a way that I can lock out this fingerprint reader while still having it on for my convenience most of the time? Again, and I don't want to be in a situation, because it's sort of like my entire life is on my phone. I don't want them having access to my email and, whatever
else,
my Facebook.
Once they have access to your email, they've got access to everything.
Right, exactly.
So, good suggestion. Thank you, Johnson, for that. What prompted this was Mike's call, where he was a little concerned about having a dash cam and, well, what would stop the police from grabbing the dash cam, grabbing you, throwing the dash cam on the ground, smashing your head against the pavement? Well, nothing really, ultimately. Right. I mean, if they want to do that, I mean, if they're in an urban area with witnesses around, they wouldn't do that. But if you're out in the middle, but we've certainly seen cops do that anyway. Rodney King, of course, one of the classic examples. So even having people around doesn't necessarily protect you. It reminds me of that video of the pastor who's kind of a jerk, from what I understand. But the pastor who got pulled from his car at a border checkpoint and beaten, basically they smashed the window in and grabbed him through the window. Essentially, you don't know what's going to happen. But I think it's still important to do the right thing in these circumstances, because it's important to record the police. If everybody's afraid of what the police might do, and we all know what they're capable of. Now, again, some cops are better than others, obviously, and many cops will not do these things to you. But we know what some of them are capable of doing, and it's just part of the reality of dealing with the police. I mean, you want to try to de-escalate conflict. You want to try to hold them as accountable as possible and hope that having a video camera makes them behave better than they otherwise would. But there's no guarantees. It is possible that having that video camera could set a cop off and encourage them to behave in a worse, more dangerous manner than they would have previously. Anything's possible. It's like dealing with a rabid dog. You don't know what that thing is going to do. So beware. But also be cautious. And that's another reason why it's a good idea to have somebody with you, especially if you're going out for the purpose of recording the police. It's one thing if you get pulled over and you've got your dash cam rolling and it's just sort of a routine traffic stop. Odds are good that if a cop's just going to write you a ticket, he's probably not in the mood to smash your head off the pavement either. But if you're going out to do cop blocking, like over at copblock.org, where there are different groups of people who will go and specifically look for the police in their town and record them dealing with other people, that is definitely more likely to cause the police to pay attention to you in a negative fashion. But if you're not alone and you further outnumber the police, then the police are likely to leave you be in those circumstances. But
I think
there are no guarantees.
I think the other thing that needs to be said about these dash cams, though, is that 99 times out of 100, the dash cam is going to be for, you got a speeding ticket, you weren't speeding, or, the cop says you rolled through a stop sign, you came to a complete stop, you got evidence, or somebody rear-ends you, it's completely private situations where somebody sideswipes you, somebody rear-ends you, something happens in traffic that you need evidence of. That's what the dash cam is going to be useful for 99 times out of 100. It's not going to be, you're not most of the time going to have to be worrying about a cop, smashing in your window with a mag light and, then ripping you out of your vehicle and putting a gun to your head. I mean, that's just.
You're also likely to get that viral video, the thing that happens in front of you on the road.
the meteor that lands and, the spaceship that flies by. Yeah. And
sometimes you see some crazy stuff.
Knock on your window. I mean,
I've gotten a few accidents on my dash cam. I haven't, had any particular reason to use them beyond saving them, but I've had them out there.
I mean, actually, the crazy, I am sort of being facetious, but citing some videos, I mean, I've seen, you can see on YouTube, like there's one where a guy catches a plane crash. One where it's that Russian, actually there are several of
the
Russian meteor or whatever that just streaked across the sky.
One of the craziest ones I've seen was there was like a truck that had a back full of helium canisters and it just, I don't know what the hell happened to it, if it just, it crashed or something like that, and these canisters explode, and then they proceed to continue to explode and like fly around everywhere for
yes, they do.
Several minutes after that.
Wait, and are they helium or they hydrogen?
Maybe like they were hydrogen. Okay. I don't know what the hell they
were. Was
there
fire?
Well, lots of fire,
okay,
yeah.
Helium's not flammable, okay, so it's so definitely then, hydrogen.
Yeah, hydrogen. So I didn't, you know, do so good in science class. But it was really entertaining, and it's super dangerous if you were there as well.
Yeah.
I mean, these things were shooting everywhere.
Oh, yeah, there, I'm sure there would be shrapnel, too. Yeah. You know, that's crazy.
I read an article, I think it was yesterday, that the Earth is losing its helium.
Oh, was really?
That, okay. What does that mean?
Well, it doesn't mean much, but it's lighter than air, just heading on up.
Is that a joke?
No.
Okay.
No. Seriously. Yeah. The Earth is losing.
Because of, like, the ozone layer or something like that? Or
yeah.
What?
No, it's just lighter than air. Right.
Okay. Well, then how did it keep it this whole time?
Well, it creates new helium, I would assume.
Okay. Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. We can talk about the 16 reasons why opening our borders makes more sense than militarizing them from the Huffington Post. Also, I mentioned Open Bazaar earlier. I've got the story about that. Is it going to be the next Silk Road? Plus, more details about the microdosing. I've got a more detailed story here from Raw Story, where study participants functioned normally in their work and relationships. So apparently there was some sort of a study involved in this. One of the researchers said that microdosing turns out to be a totally different world. He says that you could have a really great day when you do this. They function normally in their work and relationships, but with increased focus, emotional clarity, and creativity. One physician reported that microdosing LSD put him in touch with a deep place of ease and beauty. A singer reported being better able to hear and channel music. In his book, a user named Madeline offered this report, quote, "Microdosing of 10 to 20 micrograms of LSD allowed me to increase my focus, open my heart, and achieve breakthrough results while remaining integrated within my routine. My wit, response time, and visual and mental acuity seem greater than normal on it." Remember, I think it was Steve Jobs from Apple who credited his trip on LSD as one of the five most important experiences of his life, if I'm recalling that correctly.
Something like that. I think it's use of LSD.
Yeah, 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live. Hour 2 next.
It is the year 91,001 BCE. Witness humanity's origins in Hypercronius, a classic role-playing game for Windows PCs with a story like no other game before. The liberty-oriented experience that is not to be missed. Go to zog.ninja to get your copy of Hypercronius today. Use the code FTL to get $1 off. Hypercronius. ZOG.ninja. Code FTL.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With 4, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 2 is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Thursday, June 18th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.16 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,187 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $250. Antiwar.com reports Saudi warplanes attacked a civilian convoy north of the southern Yemeni port city of Aden, killing at least 31 civilians in what is among the single deadliest incident in the three-month-long Saudi war against Yemen. Medical officials say the civilians were fleeing northward from Aden, a city which has been the site of constant fighting between pro-Saudi forces and Shiite Houthis. The convoy included a bus carrying 16 passengers, which was among the targets the warplane hit. Saudi strikes over the course of the war have killed many hundreds of civilians, over 1,000 by some reckoning, and appear to have done little to reverse Houthi gains in the territory, leaving their own faction with only a handful of possessions nationwide and the leadership pretty much entirely in exile. There are peace talks going on in Geneva aiming to resolve the war, though the Saudis aren't directly in talks with the Houthis, and the pro-Saudi Yemeni government in exile is demanding unconditional Houthi surrender if they want to have any talk at all.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports the Federal Communications Commission will fine telecommunications company AT&T $100 million for apparently misleading consumers about unlimited wireless data plans. AT&T apparently sold unlimited data plans to customers but then capped and slowed their data speed after customers used a set amount of data each billing cycle. The company continued this practice without telling the consumer, according to the FCC. FCC Chairman Tom Wheeler said in a statement, "Consumers deserve to get what they pay for. Broadband providers must be upfront and transparent about the services they provide. The FCC will not stand idly by while consumers are deceived by misleading marketing material and insufficient disclosure." The FCC receives thousands of complaints from consumers of AT&T's unlimited data plan since 2011. The company responded by stating it slowed down the speeds of some users who used data heavily to make sure services ran adequately. The company also asserted it was fully transparent with consumers. AT&T spokesman Michael Balmoris said in a statement, "We will vigorously dispute the FCC's assertion. The FCC has specifically identified this practice as a legitimate and reasonable way to manage network resources for the benefit of all consumers."
When her plush and comfy life suddenly and unexpectedly fell apart, Brooke and her dog Cloud set out to defy the odds. If this is a man's world, as they say, living on the streets is no place for a young woman. One day she awoke in the Redwood Forest and realized she had become a hobo, and would ultimately come to know exactly what it means to survive. How to Be a Hobo by Brooke Willett is available from Amazon.com and all major bookstores.
Reuters reports a driver for Uber is an employee, not a contractor, according to a California ruling that eventually could push up costs for the smartphone-based ride-hailing service and hurt the closely watched startup's valuation. The California Labor Commission's decision could ripple through the burgeoning industry of providing services via smartphones, with potential implications for other crowdsourced services such as Uber rival Lyft, chore service TaskRabbit, and cleaning service HomeJoy. The ruling, which Uber insisted applied only to one driver, was the latest in a series of legal and regulatory challenges facing the company and other highly valued startups in the United States and other countries. The June 3rd ruling, which applies only in California, came to light on Tuesday after Uber appealed it in a filing in state court in San Francisco, where both the company and the driver in the case are based. Classifying Uber drivers as employees could mean considerably higher cost for the company, including Social Security, workers' compensation, and unemployment insurance. Because it is appealing the ruling, Uber will not have to change the way it does business for now. Uber said in a statement that officials in five other states have found that its drivers are independent contractors. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
It's the Onion Radio News. God loses his decision-making coin. This is Doyle Redland reporting. The Lord God has confirmed that he has misplaced his special decision-making coin. The coin, a relatively unremarkable 1972 nickel, has been used almost daily by the Supreme Being for over 4 billion years for the purpose of determining everything from the direction of the wind to the outcome of history. The visibly distraught god added,
I have no idea where I put it. I remember flipping it last night for a couple in Monroe, Michigan, who were trying to conceive a child, but I haven't seen it since.
God also said he hopes to locate the coin before 7:15 Thursday morning when United Flight 251 takes off from Seattle with actress Dixie Carter on board. Doyle Redland for The Onion Radio News, online at theonion.com.
This is The Onion News Network.
Sure what the hell happened to the music bed there, but anyway, there were some technical difficulties on the phone lines over at the network yesterday, so maybe there's still some problems. Our toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE, and with you in the studio, you've got me, Ian.
And Johnson.
And Mark.
Hey, and don't forget, you can join us online. Just drop on by freetalklive.com to enjoy the features that we share with you there. Once again, freetalklive.com. Johnson, you and I both had the same story in our show prep here tonight, and that's usually a good indicator. It's something we should talk about. And it's about cuss words being made illegal again.
Yep.
I mean, this isn't the first time some jurisdiction or whatever, some political jurisdiction has tried something
like
this.
They just want to waste more money in getting their stuff overturned in the Supreme Court.
Apparently. Well, of course, it's not like it's their money. They're wasting taxpayer dollars on this. I remember when it was, a couple of years ago. It was right when Derek Jay got out of jail after being locked up from his victimless crime spree. A town in Massachusetts had made cursing in public illegal. And so we promptly got Derek out of jail, where we went down to said town and cursed on the steps of there's definitely something going on there with the ice stand line. Cursed on the steps of town hall. So this is ripe for civil disobedience, I think. But what's the story?
Sure would be ripe. I mean, you think about the case that you could bring against them for, you know, unlawful whatever. You know, like, you think you could take them to court for their time and wasting your time with all this unconstitutional mess. Anyway, the story is Virginia just banned using cuss words in public. No, this law was not written in the 1800s. And yes, the police are actually enforcing a Virginia ban on using curse words. If you are in the city of Arlington, you could be faced with a $250 fine if you say words that county officials have defined as profanity. The Arlington County Board recently approved the bizarre measure, which increases penalties for both public intoxication as well as what they are calling blue language from $150 to $250. This code change was adopted during last Saturday's board meeting, not in 1852. It came at the request of the Arlington Police Department itself, which reported making 664 arrests for public inebriation as well as potty language in 2014 alone.
So hold on.
They're busy.
So this was already illegal? They're just now increasing the fine
for it? In the entire state of Virginia.
Yeah.
Wow.
I guess that maybe there was something, it has to do with public inebriation before, which they're now changing to intoxication and maybe also adding the bad language. I'm not sure. Now they say that they want more latitude to include a wider array of words that they can arrest people for. Of course they do. We ask the
when it comes to police, I hear them, I've heard in many occasions police, especially when we watch videos and this sort of thing, using very foul language with the citizens that they're arresting.
I'm surprised they aren't asking for, we need to have a wider array of words that we can arrest people for. Therefore, we are requesting to include in the list of banned words, words such as the, and, for, and a.
Well, it's pretty ridiculous, but I think that before we start with getting citizens to clean up their language, we need to start with getting police officers to clean up theirs. As far as I'm
concerned, they'll be exempted from the statute.
They won't be enforced on them if they're not exempted from them. They'll certainly, it's unlikely it'll be enforced. I think there should be a little demerit for police officers that use unprofessional language in dealing with the public. When you're on your break or when you're in your lunchtime, fine, you can cuss up a blue streak. But when you're carrying around the force of the people, supposedly is the idea here. You should be using professional language.
I had wondered why there was this picture of this little boy with the glasses and a popsicle in his mouth.
You know, you never saw that Christmas Carol?
That's a bar of soap.
Yeah, from that movie.
I don't know.
A really, really famous old
movie. You put your eye out with it.
Yeah, I guess I haven't seen that.
They say that we asked the police as well as city officials how many of those 664 arrests were specifically for the use of such blue language, but both declined to tell us the breakdown. Mm-hmm. City officials did note, however, that the new revised regulation replaced the words drunkenness with intoxication so that they can more easily crack down on anyone if they appear intoxicated.
Sir, you are too high on life. You're under arrest.
Even if they don't have any alcohol in their system. The ordinance adopted by Arlington is not unique to the city. It actually brings the city in line with the broader statewide Virginia law, which bans profanity and classifies it as a Class 4 misdemeanor punishable by a fine of up to $250.
This is unbelievable. I mean, is CounterCurrent News legit? I mean, is this for real?
I googled it to make sure.
You googled the Virginia
profanity? I liked this version of the story, but I googled to
I mean, I've seen some stories there at CounterCurrent News, and we've certainly used them in the past. And usually there's a citation there, and I don't see a citation on this particular
story. Well, if you Google Arlington ban, you will find a story from, I believe, the New York Post or something. Wow. There's some other ones that are out there. But I liked this version the way it was written. You know, I would really, as scary as it is, I would really love to see more citizens' arrests start happening for these laws. So, for example, New Hampshire is about to have a law as of July 1st that you cannot touch a cell phone or a mobile device, as it states within the, in the law, even if the car is on a roadway or whatever, even if it's parked. You cannot touch a mobile device while you're in your vehicle. So I would love to see
people sitting in a stoplight, for instance.
Yeah, sitting in a stoplight parked on the side of the road, any of those things.
I believe if you're parked on the side of the road, you can. There are certain exemptions within the law.
In a parking lot, you cannot be on a public way. So parked on the side of the road would count as being on a public way. That would be a problem. So that means that if a police officer is parked in a public way and
then
goes to...
Have you read the law?
Yeah, I have.
Okay.
So if a police officer, I would think that if a police officer is parked in a public way and then touches one of the computers in their vehicles, that they would be susceptible to this law. If a police officer is cursing at someone, they should be in Arlington, Virginia, they should be susceptible to that law. And
police
I would think that they should be able
to
be fined or, but they're not exempted.
They're frequently exempted.
They're exempted in court.
Yeah.
But what I'm saying is because no one's arresting them. The cops, they have their thin blue line. Well, I think there needs to be a citizen line.
In some laws, they are actually specifically exempted, the wiretapping
I agree.
Laws.
Yeah, some places they are specifically exempted. But what I'm saying is in most cases with these silly laws, they're not. But no one enforces it on them because no one can. But most places do have rules for citizens' arrest, and I'd like to see that happen more often.
Well, I would think it would be relatively dangerous, but when you get people on video, when you get the cops on video, it tends to go viral when you catch them doing dirt.
If you want to share your thoughts with us, maybe you're in Virginia and you have some experience with this intoxication/profanity law, and I guess it's not real clear to me how long this has been on the books, but it's apparently not new. What's new is that it's Arlington that's increasing the fines.
Right. Just brought it to everybody's attention. Yeah. I imagine a lot of places have these blue laws as far as what you can cussing and all that sort of thing. Mm-hmm. And I don't want to see somebody downtown cursing up a blue streak either when I'm with my family. But, that's kind of one of the problems with public. It's full of the public and most
and
of the public.
There's lots of undesirables in the public.
Sorry. Good portion of the public. Not such great people.
You know, the only time I've ever seen a blue streak is on those stupid stickers that people who support the cops have. What is that? What is a blue streak?
The blue, thin blue line?
Right.
Are you seriously asking that question?
Well, no. What's the difference between... Okay, no. He just said cursing up a blue streak. So if you're cursing up a blue streak, does that mean that this behavior is attributed to cops?
No, I don't think it is attributed to anything
so
like that.
So what is this blue streak versus the blue streak on the cop sticker? I mean, it seems to me like very specifically it's the same thing. Either that or, somebody trying to say cops are profane or cops trying to say that they're profane.
No,
why is their logo a blue streak?
For whatever reason... There is, you know, the blue is the term they use for dirty things, bad language.
I think cops are dirty things, and I think that they're publicly acknowledging it with their gang symbol.
Now, the thin blue line is a relatively new thing compared to cussing up a blue streak.
Right. Cussing up a blue streak came first. So the cops now have said, oh, well, we'll put a blue streak as our logo because we are dirty. We're dirty cops. Protect us. We protect each other from the law because we're dirty.
You sound like you're frustrated, my friend. You know, this is.
I think that they're just acknowledging their behavior publicly and openly. We protect one another from justice because we have a thin blue line, because we're dirty and we do things in a blue streak.
Well, I would not expect to see police arresting each other for this,
certainly
this
not.
Crime.
By the way, I did find a story that actually does list the statute itself. What does it actually say? We'll come back with more here. 855, 450, free. And there's some other pretty ridiculous stuff that's illegal there in Virginia. More on the way. You can share your thoughts with us here on Free Talk Live.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
All loans subject to one Dex Corp. Must be business at least 1 year to apply.
Attention small business owners needing financing. Are you too busy running your business to deal with the slow lending process of your bank? Are you frustrated at the paperwork and delays just trying to get a decision? Then you need OnDeck, the A+ Better Business Bureau rated small business experts, where our simple application process takes as little as 10 minutes and funding could be available in just one business day. At OnDeck, we focus on your business operation and cash flow, not just your personal credit score. And we're ready to help with loans of up to $250,000. True business loans, not credit card advances. OnDeck provides financing to a wide variety of small businesses like restaurants, plumbing, landscaping, freight trucking, and healthcare providers. If you're frustrated with the paperwork and long decision times of traditional lenders, contact OnDeck. Funding could be available in just one business day. OnDeck is publicly listed on the New York Stock Exchange and has provided over $2 billion to small businesses like yours. So go to OnDeckLending.com today or call 800-293-6819. That's 800-293-6819.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com. Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us and bring up anything you want to discuss at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Just drop on by freetalklive.com. Please enjoy the features on the site. They are totally free. Once again, that's freetalklive.com. Mark, tell me about Quantum Vibe.
Well, Quantum Vibe, the liberty-oriented epic sci-fi web story, has concluded. Now, you can get the final volume. That's volume 3. It'll be available at the end of the month, the last day of the month. But you can, if you happen to be at the Porcupine Freedom Festival, you can get it a few days early on Wednesday, so please stop by Site 27. Now, Quantum Vibe Venus 23 has recently started up, so there's a new story coming in the Quantum Vibe universe. It's set. It's an all-new story. It's got some of the same characters and a lot of new ones. Check it out, quantumvibe.com. It's quantumvibe.com. There'll be a link there for Big Head Press. If you click through there, you'll be able to find all their older stories, too. And there's just a lot of them. So if you're interested in liberty-oriented web comics, this is the place to go, quantumvibe.com.
All right, we can talk more about the ridiculous law banning profanity across all of Virginia. Apparently, it's been around for a little while. We'll get into that, or we can get more into that here in a moment. But let's go first to the phones and to the fun, where actually we've got Neil on Skype in New Hampshire. Hello, Neil. You're on Free Talk Live.
Hey guys, how are you doing?
Hey, good, good. You're a little bit loud. I don't know if you want to back away from your microphone just a little bit.
Oh, sorry about that. Is that better?
It's a little better. Go ahead.
Oh, that sounds great, yeah.
Okay, great. So I just wanted to call in and give an update on the Liberland situation. Over the past couple of days, you've kind of brought this up and had an interview with the president of the Liberland Settlement Association.
Yeah, Nicholas Nicolaisen was on the phones with us a few days back. And for those who don't know, how would you define Liberland, Neil? What is it?
So Liberland is the world's newest nation. And so it's a patch of unclaimed land between Croatia and Serbia, right off the Danube. And for a couple months now, we've been actively trying to settle it. There are people over there camped out, making crossings pretty much every other day, trying to thwart what is practically now a blockade of Croatians, preventing people from settling on land that Croatia itself says they don't own.
Yeah. Really, the only crime here is the exiting Croatia or entering Croatia from a non-checkpoint. Right.
Right. So they're actually doing a really good job of policing our borders of Liberland. So people have been arrested for crossing from Croatia into Liberland, but they've also been arrested by navigating freely on the Danube and landing on land that Croatia doesn't own. So.
So you can take a boat up and down the Danube anytime you want. You can come onto Liberland without crossing into Croatia from the Danube, and they'll still come after you, right?
Right, and there are international agreements that they are violating. There's one called the Danube Convention, which, among other things, provides for free passage of vessels, prohibits countries from policing land on the Danube, all the signatories to it that they themselves don't have control over. So in Croatia says that this land is Serbian. Serbia says that Liberland is not Serbian. And so that provides the opportunity for someone to go there and claim it, which we have. But unfortunately, every time we do, and you all highlighted recently some of the recent arrests, they they violently invade international territory, crossing a border. And today they've done the same thing. And
yeah, the video is up over at the Liberland Facebook page of the arrest. And it looks like today it was just one guy, but they have arrested, according to the president of the Liberland Settlement Association, they've arrested something like 24 people, or there have been 24 arrests thus far. And I notice you're saying we and our. Are you a Liberland citizen?
I have not obtained that distinction yet, albeit I am involved with Liberland Settlement Association in helping both with their online efforts and their press releases and everything else. I've also donated to them too. So, you know, I certainly am invested to an extent, and I would love to go there and do plan to go there to, you know, check things out, help out the cause. Don't think I'm about to get arrested and thrown into a Balkan prison cell because we've seen actually how they treat some of the other settlers.
Yeah, tell me about
one,
that.
One gentleman, he was 17. He was arrested again by crossing not from Croatia to Liberland, but, you know, through the waterways. And he was held without water, access to water or access to food or even daylight, which all three are in contravention of the Geneva Conventions. For 23 hours, despite his pleas.
And now, they actually held somebody else at the same time, and they held the other person longer, because I remember that story. The 17-year-old was released first. There was another person who was taken with him who was older. That person was held, I imagine, in similar conditions for a longer period of time.
I don't have the full story on the conditions for that person, but it wasn't pleasant
For sure.
Everything.
Well, I don't think that you have to actually cross into Liberland to become a citizen, right? I mean, we were talking with, you know, like you said, Nicholas Nikolaisen from the Liberland Settlement Association, and asked him about citizenship. There have been over nearly almost 500,000 applications put in, and what I think he said over 100 had been approved, and it was a requirement that someone be invested in some way in this, like monetarily, but also going to the base camp that they've set up in Serbia and spending a couple of weeks there. So you could probably get your citizenship without actually having to commit civil disobedience.
Right. So if your boots on the ground in any fashion, that's highly respected, and I'm sure that's, you know, a foot in the door. But you know, we've had the same thing happen today again, and today was the first time where one of the settlers peacefully and passively resisted.
Yeah, I saw that
so
on the video.
He did not offer any, you know, help, and activists in New Hampshire have done that too when they've gotten arrested. But what they ended up doing to him was essentially throwing him on the ground, kneeing him in the back, handcuffing him, and then dragging him by his arms in a very painful fashion, we can only imagine, and throwing him into their high-speed boat, face down, too, as they, you know, sped off. So it's probably pretty dangerous.
Yeah, like bouncing up and down the bottom of the boat like a trout.
Face down, yep, exactly. So we're really concerned about his safety just going through that, and then also what's happening to him now. We believe he'll be in court tomorrow, but really to secure that Liberland is, you know, somewhat marshy. There's a lot of mosquitoes. Is not the most pleasant place to build a society, but it's, you know, admittedly one that's extremely free right now, save for the Croatian forces. So the thing that we have to overcome and that we have to continue challenging, and what today was about as well, is highlighting the ways in which Croatia, a signatory to many treaties and also
stand by,
a
member state. More coming up. Free Talk Live.
Yep. Attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Are Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
Hey guys, Mark Claire here, LionsOfLiberty.com, where we strive to advance the ideas of liberty daily. We bring you The Morning Roar! That's right, every Monday to Friday, we'll have a brand new edition of The Morning Roar, where we provide a roundup of some news stories that you may not find in the mainstream media or even in your typical social media news feed. We find stories that relate to the ideas of liberty and provide you with our liberty perspective on them. Every Monday, we have our longest-running feature, Mondays with Murray, named after the great libertarian Murray Rothbard, where we'll examine an article or an excerpt from his works and help convey his view, along with our little spin as well. We wrap it all up every Friday with Felony Friday, where our own John Odermatt goes out and takes a look at some sort of felony. There's felonies committed every day, you know, whether it's a felony committed by the police, a politician, or even an average citizen. You can find all of this and so much more over at LionsOfLiberty.com. Advancing the ideas of liberty daily.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, join us here toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Open Bazaar is in the news again. Will it be the Silk Road killer or the replacement for the Silk Road? We can continue with, we can start that discussion up here in a little bit. But first, we're going to continue with Neil, who is with us from New Hampshire. He's very excited about Liberland. And, well, of course, there's some very scary things that are going on for some of the people who are part of Liberland, which is a 3-square-mile plot of land between Croatia and Serbia where people are attempting to settle. But when they cross into Liberland, they're being arrested by Croatian government goons. So we're going to talk more about that here in a moment. Maybe the folks over at Liberland could use the Peacekeeper app once version 2.0 comes out. And we've talked about Peacekeeper in the past here on Free Talk Live, and they are looking to revamp the app. and they're launching an Indiegogo campaign to release Peacekeeper 2.0 as the world's first alternative to dialing 911. It was a hit, but there were some problems with the 1.0 release, like limited features and some bugs, unfortunately, and a lack of a real network. They've spent the past 6 months learning from the mistakes of the first app, and they've learned what doesn't work and learned what does work and how to build on it. Peacekeeper 2.0 has the potential to be world-changing. They're creating new features like a verified network of peacekeepers that you can call in an emergency. No longer will you have to just rely on your groups and alliances. Now every peacekeeper in the area is a potential ally. So just so you know, Peacekeeper was a system designed to sort of have an emergency response with your friends instead of strangers, right? So normally you would call for a fire or some sort of medical emergency.
Set it up with your neighbors.
And a bunch of government guys show up and you don't know what they're going to do. But if it's your neighbors, then maybe they'll act with more care and compassion than some of the government guys. I'm not saying the EMS...
Sometimes you don't want to go all the way up to, you know, calling the emergency services either. Yeah.
And I'm not saying EMS will be uncompassionate or something like that, but it's just that some people would feel better their neighbors being the first responders and their friends being first responders rather than the government bureaucrats. So Peacekeeper can allow you to do that, and the new version is going to make it even better. They're hiring a new developer to create a powerful bug-free system, and they're renovating their marketing and hoping they can bring in 100,000 users next year and show the state what real change looks like, and they need your help. Peacekeeper is more than an app. It's a movement. It's a revolutionary system that is designed to challenge the status quo. It's a tool that will allow ordinary people to stand up and be heroes. It's a fast, flexible alert system that can help keep you safe better than dialing 911. Peacekeeper can change the world, and you can help by contributing to their Indiegogo campaign today at pk.freetalklive.com. That's PK like Peacekeeper. pk.freetalklive.com. That'll take you right to their Indiegogo. If you want to see Peacekeeper 2.0 revolutionize what protection means, you can contribute to their Indiegogo campaign today at pk.freetalklive.com. As we go back to Neil with us here in New Hampshire, back via Skype. Neil, you were driving at a point when we had to jump out to the break there. Can you sort of recap where you were going?
Yeah, sure. And I got to say, I'm really excited about New Hampshire and the Free State Project, too. We at least have running water here. But
it's nice.
But so Liberland is unsettled at this point. It's unclaimed land between Croatia and Serbia. It's unsettled, but with the amount of entrepreneurs and really great minds that have come together over this, just, you know, hundreds of doers that have, you know, really chimed in and started making plans. We can build a free society within Liberland if we just have the opportunity. And the one thing that's standing in our way right now is Croatian police acting outside of their jurisdiction. The Croatian courts admitted that Liberland is not Croatia. Their own official government maps do not list Liberland in Croatia. And so, you know, we have a pretty solid case that this is neither country's land. And, you know, the point of today's action, putting a settler on Liberland again, unfortunately, he got arrested, just like many others, was to continue to highlight how they're, you know, acting outside of both the treaties that they're party to, the Geneva Convention, how they treat the prisoners that they abduct.
How do you make them stop? I mean, it's pretty clear that they're acting outside of their jurisdiction.
Just being an EU member state, they're a freshly minted EU member.
We just lost Neil. At least there is some sort of a technical difficulty.
It doesn't
there.
In my mind.
Sorry, go ahead. You were cut off for about 20 seconds there.
Oh, sorry.
Freshly minted EU member.
Certainly doesn't. Yeah, and this certainly doesn't look good for them. For that, I should hope. So, you know, part of what we're doing is contacting international organizations such as the Red Cross, and really trying to highlight, this cause. It's one thing standing in our way.
Well, what I'm wondering here is can that EU status be used in some way? Because they're basically just going on to territory that's not theirs, stepping outside of their jurisdiction and dragging people off. We would have settled Liberland by now if it hadn't been for the fact that the Croatian police keep dragging people off.
Yeah, it's, there's all sorts of you know, interesting legal aspects of, you know, we've gotten into in our discussion forums, and we have a legal advisor too. And a couple of lawyers who have chimed in, and lawyers representing our settlers in Croatian courts. So there's some good legal minds jumping in on this. So I think it's a matter of time, and we just really have to press to the international community how they're acting outside.
Neil,
and,
thanks.
I was just going to say one of the interesting things we've uncovered too is that there are logging. Croatian logging companies that have purchased rights to the land of Liberland from the Croatian government or are leasing them. So there's actually some corporate interest in here too that may get pretty hairy down the line.
So they sold rights to logging companies over land they have no legal jurisdiction over.
Exactly.
This is a mess, and it's
three square miles. They're not giving up much, though.
Yeah, it's certainly going to be interesting to watch this as it develops. And Neil, thanks for the update tonight. Appreciate hearing from you. In fact, I heard a rumor that there may be a certain president of Liberland who may be attending the Porcupine Freedom Festival.
Oh, that'd be awesome.
I don't know if it's going to happen. He's going to have to buy his own plane ticket, and if he can afford to do that, it's my understanding Porkfest will certainly make room for him to speak with a fairly prominent speaking place on the schedule. So that could be really cool. So stay tuned for more information about that as the Porcupine Freedom Festival looms closer. We are just days away from the kickoff on Sunday.
So I just found out about a piece of news that is tech news that occurred today.
I want to hear about it in a moment. But first, George is on the line in North Carolina. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian Johnson and Mark.
Oh, I'm an occasional listener, and I have a solution to the problem in Arlington County.
Okay.
Yeah. Let's have two guys go into a shirt shop and have a shirt made up. The first one says, you no good bastard. Second line says, you know, pee off or whatever. 1 through 10, and then have them stand outside the courthouse shouting numbers at each other.
That's funny. You should do that.
You know, I mean, you're not cursing, but they're shouting the numbers off the shirts.
I wonder if they can get you for having the shirt, though.
I don't think so. I there are a lot of crazy shirts out there.
Yeah, you might be right here. I'm looking at the actual law. This is Section 18.2-388 of the Virginia Code. It says, quote, if any person profanely curses or swears or is intoxicated in public, then they go on, they're talking more about intoxication.
Guys are shouting numbers at each other. What's the problem?
George, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So, yeah, all it really says, this is mostly all about being intoxicated. It says here you'll be guilty of a Class 4 misdemeanor, which I presume is a fairly low-class misdemeanor. And all it says is if any person profanely curses or swears. That doesn't say if any person wears a T-shirt.
So that sounded like a pun, a fairly low-class misdemeanor.
It did. We'll talk about your tech news coming up here in a moment. Can you tease it, Johnson?
Sure. I mean, it's real brief. Apparently, there's a thing that says that the FCC has been subsidizing phone service for low-income people. Well, now they're going to subsidize broadband.
Oh, dear. All right, we can talk about it. You can bring up whatever's on your mind here and join us on Free Talk Live at 855-450-FREE. Plus more tech coming up.
It is the year 91,001 BCE. Witness humanity's origins in Hypercronius, a classic role-playing game for Windows PCs with a story like no other game before. The liberty-oriented experience that is not to be missed. Go to zog.ninja to get your copy of Hypercronius today. Use the code FTL to get $1 off. Hypercronius, ZOG.ninja, code FTL.
The results are in. For the treatment of nasal allergy symptoms, nothing is more effective than Nasacort. Nasacort Allergy 24-Hour is prescription-strength medicine that's scent and alcohol-free with no harsh taste. It's non-addictive and provides 24-hour relief of the worst nasal allergy symptoms, including congestion, with no prescription needed. And in a recent clinical study with Nasacort going nose-to-nose with Flonase, more people prefer Nasacort. For more information, visit nasacort.com. Nasacort. Use as directed.
How many good people procrastinate? When was the last time you updated your last will and testament, your living will, and your health care power of attorney? If you could get these documents included with your Legal Shield membership for no additional charge, wouldn't it just make sense to have the peace of mind of owning a Legal Shield membership? Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com or call 855-340-SAVE. That's 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey system. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting GoBerkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free here to join us and bring up what you want. 855-450-FREE is the number. That's 855-450-3733. Johnson found a story about the FCC going to be subsidizing broadband internet.
Yeah, they made this decision today, so this is sort of breaking news.
Well, now, you know, the FCC has more control over the internet with the whole net neutrality thing, so you shouldn't be surprised when...
Let's power grab some more. Yeah. What else can we take?
Give the government a little bit, and they'll take the whole ring.
Well, God knows we couldn't handle a free internet.
FCC announced plans last month to subsidize, this from Engadget.com, broadband internet service for low-income households. Today, the commission voted on the matter, approving the addition of internet subsidies to the Lifeline program.
Ian, and clearly now that internet access is subsidized, we have to say that internet access is right. And because internet access is right...
Is a right, you mean?
It's a right, yeah. Right. So, you know, internet access is a right, obviously, because it's being subsidized. And because it's a right, that means children have access to it. And because children have access to it, clearly the government should be able to censor the internet. Mm. And if they're able to censor the internet, clearly they need to control the information that people have access to. Just like,
oh, that couldn't happen here, Johnson.
Oh, oh yes, that sounds it could.
Like, that sounds crazy talk. Right.
Yeah, give them time. Luckily, I trust the geeks, and I think the geeks can keep the internet free. I believe in them.
Let's hope.
So less than half of the homes that make less than $25,000 have internet access, and today's vote offers help and provides steps to oversee the process too. For example, service providers will no longer verify eligibility. That task will be given to a third party instead. The vote also set the subsidy rate at $9.25 per month for both internet and phone service. Where does that money come from? fees paid by service providers that are listed on customers' monthly bills. The FCC is looking to ensure not only the program's efficiency, but to cut down on fraud and establish a set budget as well. Blah, blah, blah. So,
the thoughts that were rolling around in my head were really pessimistic when you're like, the geeks will keep it free. I trust in the geeks. And I'm thinking like, well, last generation's geeks were like, what, Einstein and Oppenheimer and, you know, what did they do with their geekly power? Oh, they built nuclear weapons.
Well, I think the evidence shows that the people who are behind the internet is a relatively, at least a lot of them are libertarian oriented.
There are
folks.
A lot of libertarian geeks, but I don't know, there are also a lot of non-libertarian geeks.
Yeah, they're working for the NSA, right? Yeah.
You don't have to be a non-libertarian you don't have to be a libertarian to appreciate freedom of speech. And I think there's a large, contingent of people out there. Remember, what was it, SOPA or whatever it was called,
sure.
Where the government wanted to put some sort of restrictions on the internet, and the internet went into protest mode. Basically, a lot of people, a lot of websites putting up protest banners and things like that, and
the thing
making
is,
phone calls.
It works. The system for getting a bill through Congress is the same system for getting a bill past the internet. You keep saying the same thing over and over again, and at some point mm-hmm. people begin to negotiate with you. Okay, well, you can put limits here, put limits there. Look at Amazon. They were against a national sales tax or whatever it is, them having to pay sales tax and to states they're shipping to or whatever, but they're beginning to slip on that issue.
So if you want to share your thoughts, you can join us here at 855-450-FREE. Regarding the subsidies in this particular case, I think it's a bummer that people who are currently paying for broadband are now going to be subsidizing people who are poor with their habits, right? Because a lot of people are poor not because of how they were born or whatever, although that certainly can start off in a...
How dare you?
It can certainly
start.
You're
blaming the victim.
In a difficult portion in life, but...
Well, I've heard commercials on the radio where they're saying that 1 in 5 children struggle with hunger. Now, I'm not sure what struggle with hunger means.
In the United States.
Does that mean they eat too many potato chips and not enough broccoli?
You're talking about in the U.S.?
That's what they're talking about, in the U.S. 1 out of 5 kids in the U.S. struggles with hunger. Mm-hmm. And, for me, what that draws up is that they're hungry, right? Like you've seen kids in Africa or Eritrea or wherever.
Not the same, I don't think.
I'm thinking not. I suspect not. I don't want to be completely callous here. But I want to see the person who's starving. I imagine there has to be somebody. Some parent has some kid locked in a cage in the basement, right? And they just feed them banana peels. Yeah, it's happened. There's certainly been foster kids that have been put in those circumstances. But I feel lied to when they say things like struggling with hunger, which means that they're not eating enough organic fruits and vegetables or whatever. That's just bad parenting, and I can't fix all the bad parents. Sadly, it seems like the people who are most dead set on being parents in the world are the ones least qualified to do it.
I mean, I'll even go as far as when I think of hunger, and not even necessarily like Africa, like distended belly hunger, but like hunger like English, like the play Oliver Twist, where they're singing like, food, glorious. Food,
yes.
There's just may I have some more, not like completely horribly gaunt, but just struggling with hunger, like they're hungry. But 1 out of 5,
well,
it's a hard number to swallow.
I wouldn't doubt that some kids get a great deal of their nutrition from school lunch programs and school breakfast programs. They had
like prison food.
Yeah, there's no doubt. But what that does in many cases is just allow the family to reallocate funds. Right? I mean, hopefully these people are good enough parents. If they're not good enough parents to provide food to their kids, they're not good enough parents to be parents. I don't know what else to say about that. To my mind, the most important thing I can do for my child, and I have one, is to make sure that they get sustenance. I'm not even as concerned about the roof over his head as making sure that he gets the right foods so that his body and his mind can develop. And if you don't, I feel like if you don't feel the same way as me, you're not qualified to be a parent at all. Now, what do I do about that? I don't have many answers. You know, Darwin has an answer. That is that your lineage dies out because you're too busy drinking beer and smoking cigarettes or whatever. I don't want to see that happen. But exactly what are we incentivizing here?
Yeah, in this case, I mean, under $10, you know, just under $10 for internet access really isn't that much cheaper than low-tier right. broadband access. Right. If you look at, like, you know, the lowest
net
level.
Zero.
Not net zero. I don't even know if they offer broadband. I think they're a dial-up.
Yeah, broadband company. Has been redefined. I mean, at least 50 megabits per second down or something like that.
So, I mean, I'm just talking about Time Warner.
50 megabits?
Comcast.
Yep.
I don't get that.
Yep, you don't have broadband. You've been reclassified as not a broadband subscriber anymore.
What's below broadband?
Anything under 50 megabits, I believe, is what they reclassified broadband to mean now.
Under 50 megabits is broadband. Mm-hmm. I thought you said it was over 50.
Under 50 is not broadband.
So what do they call that? That's what I'm wondering.
I don't know.
It's not dial-up. It used to be dial-up, then broadband. There was nothing in between dial-up and broadband. So what's the new word for that?
Internet. I don't know.
Basic internet. Anyway, my point being that if you go and you look at the different packages, your typical cable modem package is $50 a month, but there are lower tier ones for people who can't afford or who don't need the maximum speed or even mid-range speed. I swear I have seen a package for $20 a month.
Okay. I need to redefine my... they upped it from 4 to 25. Megabits per second. Used to be 4 megabits per second.
I didn't have
that. Used to be broadband. Now it's 25 megabits, not 50. 25 megabits per second is what's considered.
But still, what is the word for under 25? That's what I want to know. If you know, the toll-free
number... Maybe high-speed internet?
Okay, 855-450-FREE. I know that Time Warner has a wideband.
I was going to say, it's whatever marketing garbage they feed you.
Yeah.
That's what it's going to be.
Who's making these determinations? Who decides what...
The FCC.
Oh, the FCC. Okay. So anyway, what I was pointing out, though, is you can get from, I believe this is true of a lot of providers, a real low tier, like 2 megabits a second downstream, just some basic internet at fairly low speeds from a cable provider for $20 a month. That's $10 a month more than this subsidy cost. And I mean, if we're talking about $10, that's a pack of cigarettes.
I just want to bring something up here real quick about this, too, that how ineffectual and how stupid this government is. It's like... We're going to make sure that broadband internet can only be defined as 25 megabits per second, and you cannot refer to anything outside of that spectrum of signal as broadband. Mm. That is prohibited for you to do. Okay, our new package is high-speed wideband internet. Lightning fast, courageous speeds with hyper channel, you know, like they just make up a new term.
For sure.
And no one knows that broadband, like... No one cares to pay attention to the FCC's stupid decisions. Like, everyone else is, like, they're not going to be aware of the difference between wideband and broadband and hyperband and lightband. And, like, no one knows that, it's only broadband that must be greater than 25 megabits per second because I am paying attention to every little thing about the internet technologies. What? You know, like, that decision is worthless.
Well, I guess the disturbing part about this is if broadband is now defined as 25 megabits or higher... then that would mean that these companies that are offering lower tier items that essentially would not satisfy the requirement for
broadband.
They just
rename them.
Anyway, we'll come back with more here. 855-450-FREE and still to come, Open Bazaar. It's back in the news. What is it? We can talk about that. Or you can bring up anything that's on your mind. Mark, you want to talk about Rand Paul's tax plan.
Yep.
It's Free Talk Live. You can take control here.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online, and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
If you want to play online poker with Bitcoin, you need a site that's trustworthy and technically sound. The site managers of swcpoker.eu have proven their commitment to bringing you great gameplay from a site you can trust, swcpoker.eu. They have lots of new games too, including Chinese poker, and their Krill leaderboard is open right now. It's a beautiful site, easy to use with lots of players. Go on over to swcpoker.eu now and have some fun with your Bitcoin. swcpoker.eu.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Thursday, June 18th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.16 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,187 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $250. Antiwar.com reports Saudi warplanes attacked a civilian convoy north of the southern Yemeni port city of Aden, killing at least 31 civilians in what is among the single deadliest incident in the three-month-long Saudi war against Yemen. Medical officials say the civilians were fleeing northward from Aden, a city which has been the site of constant fighting between pro-Saudi forces and Shiite Houthis. The convoy included a bus carrying 16 passengers, which was among the targets the warplane hit. Saudi strikes over the course of the war have killed many hundreds of civilians, over 1,000 by some reckoning, and appear to have done little to reverse Houthi gains in the territory, leaving their own faction with only a handful of possessions nationwide and the leadership pretty much entirely in exile. There are peace talks going on in Geneva aiming to resolve the war, though the Saudis aren't directly in talks with the Houthis, and the pro-Saudi Yemeni government in exile is demanding unconditional Houthi surrender if they want to have any talk at all.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports the Federal Communications Commission will fine telecommunications company AT&T $100 million for apparently misleading consumers about unlimited wireless data plans. AT&T apparently sold unlimited data plans to customers but then capped and slowed their data speed after customers used a set amount of data each billing cycle. The company continued this practice without telling the consumer, according to the FCC. FCC Chairman Tom Wheeler said in a statement, "Consumers deserve to get what they pay for. Broadband providers must be upfront and transparent about the services they provide. The FCC will not stand idly by while consumers are deceived by misleading marketing material and insufficient disclosure." The FCC receives thousands of complaints from consumers of AT&T's unlimited data plan since 2011. The company responded by stating it slowed down the speeds of some users who used data heavily to make sure services ran adequately. The company also asserted it was fully transparent with consumers. AT&T spokesman Michael Balmoris said in a statement, "We will vigorously dispute the FCC's assertion. The FCC has specifically identified this practice as a legitimate and reasonable way to manage network resources for the benefit of all consumers."
When her plush and comfy life suddenly and unexpectedly fell apart, Brooke and her dog Cloud set out to defy the odds. If this is a man's world, as they say, living on the streets is no place for a young woman. One day she awoke in the Redwood Forest and realized she had become a hobo, and would ultimately come to know exactly what it means to survive. How to Be a Hobo by Brooke Willett is available from Amazon.com and all major bookstores.
Reuters reports a driver for Uber is an employee, not a contractor, according to a California ruling that eventually could push up costs for the smartphone-based ride-hailing service and hurt the closely watched startup's valuation. The California Labor Commission's decision could ripple through the burgeoning industry of providing services via smartphones, with potential implications for other crowdsourced services such as Uber rival Lyft, chore service TaskRabbit, and cleaning service HomeJoy. The ruling, which Uber insisted applied only to one driver, was the latest in a series of legal and regulatory challenges facing the company and other highly valued startups in the United States and other countries. The June 3rd ruling, which applies only in California, came to light on Tuesday after Uber appealed it in a filing in state court in San Francisco, where both the company and the driver in the case are based. Classifying Uber drivers as employees could mean considerably higher cost for the company, including Social Security, workers' compensation, and unemployment insurance. Because it is appealing the ruling, Uber will not have to change the way it does business for now. Uber said in a statement that officials in five other states have found that its drivers are independent contractors. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
On May 22, 1992, beloved talk show host Johnny Carson ended his 30-year run of hosting The Tonight Show with a farewell episode that included special guests Saddam Hussein, KKK Grand Wizard Virgil Lee Griffin, and a musical performance by the Flag. On May 24, 1883, the Brooklyn Bridge opened, providing New Yorkers with a more efficient way of killing themselves and escaping their trash-ridden, excrement-cake city. The monument's historic opening was marked by hundreds of people jumping 275 feet to their deaths in order to avoid waking up every morning with the smell of horseshit filling their nostrils.
Before the Brooklyn Bridge, there were very few ways for New Yorkers to free themselves from the cesspool in which they lived. One method was to tie cinder blocks on their legs and walk into the Hudson River. But of course, the banks of the Hudson were so brimming with garbage and raw sewage that the putrid stench would drive back even the most desperate suicide seeker.
This is the Onion News Network.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us here on the radio waves at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online at freetalklive.com with you tonight. You've got me, Ian.
And Johnson.
And Mark.
So we've talked about a few interesting things here tonight. You're welcome to comment on any of those. Everything from taking LSD in microdoses for breakfast to apparently it's illegal to curse in Virginia, and it has been for quite a while. That law has just been, I guess, enforced a little bit tighter, or I guess updated in Arlington, Virginia. We talked about the Liberland. There's been another arrest in Liberland just today. And further, now internet is going to be subsidized for poor people. So you can comment on any of those things if you'd like. Again, our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Coming up, Mark, you want to talk about Rand Paul's tax plan, which is the first. I didn't know that, you know, as a supposed libertarian, that he would have such a thing. So I guess that's another strike against him as far as his supposed liberty-orientedness.
Oh, God. Anybody wants to, you know, somebody's running for government, they're going to be talking about how to fund government.
Harry Brown's tax plan, which was to close the IRS and then sell off pieces of the building after he takes a wrecking ball to it in order to help pay out people's Social Security funds. So anyway, let's go to another story. This is from Fortune magazine. It's about Open Bazaar. It's story says here it could be America's most dangerous tech startup. Reports emerged last week that venture capital giants Andreessen Horowitz and Union Square Ventures are investing $1 million into Open Bazaar, an online platform where users can buy and sell pretty much anything using the digital currency Bitcoin. If this sounds all too familiar, recall the Silk Road, the Bitcoin marketplace that U.S. authorities shut down last year for facilitating drug sales. Its rise and dramatic fall is the stuff of dark fiction, and I would argue that Open Bazaar is much worse. Now, again, this is the author at Fortune. I think Open Bazaar is a wonderful idea, and we've had one of the founders on to talk about it from one of the Bitcoin conventions we attended. I think he was at Austin.
Sam?
Yeah, Sam. No, he was in Orlando, wasn't he? Coins in the Kingdom. Unlike its predecessor, Open Bazaar is completely decentralized and exists wholly within the network of users themselves. In other words, even if a criminal buys guns over the peer-to-peer system, he can't be shut down without shutting down every computer in the network, which isn't really feasible since there's no central hub for law enforcement to target. So let me restate what that means here. So for those of you who are familiar with file sharing, you know that with like a torrent, for instance, or these other sort of file sharing networks out there, there's files that are on computers all around the world, let's say dozens, if not hundreds or thousands of computers, depending on the file and how popular it is. And then when you go and you request the torrent for that file, the torrent simply links you into all of those computers, and then those computers are the ones that send you the data. The data does not exist on some central computer. Normally, when you click, let's say you're downloading Free Talk
Anything
Live's
else,
archive.
Right.
Let's say you're downloading our archive of the show tonight. You're downloading that from a central resource. You're downloading it from the folks over at SoundCloud. And if SoundCloud's server goes down, then you're going to have a difficult time receiving that file. Now, thankfully, we have other files on other servers to decentralize that somewhat. But OpenBazaar decentralizes sales. It decentralizes a marketplace. So Silk Road was operated on a server in Iceland. I think it was Iceland. And that was some computer sitting in a rack somewhere, and the federal government somehow, we still don't know how, found out where this thing was, and they demanded to get a copy of the server from the company that was operating the server farm, basically. And they were able to do that. With OpenBazaar, the entire marketplace itself is not on one computer. It's on as many computers are running this OpenBazaar software. So like file sharing or like Bitcoin, this is a decentralized marketplace
right.
that, in theory, can be anonymized. Now, they did say that the initial versions would not be anonymous, so I don't know if they've gotten to that part yet with OpenBazaar's development. But when it's done, and it's not yet done, but when it's ready, it will be an anonymous service where you can sell openly if you want.
I'm sorry, the way you're saying that, like when it's ready, it's like, you know, are you saying I can dodge bullets? No, I'm saying when you're ready, you won't have to.
Maybe you want to be anonymous, maybe you won't. Some sellers don't have to be anonymous on this system,
right.
but you would be able to do that, and there would essentially be nobody who could tell you that you couldn't do it. Is
right.
my understanding. So the people who are programming OpenBazaar,
it's like the Kazaa of drugs.
They want to. Kazaa's an old file sharing service. The people who are programming this essentially are just programming a solid marketplace app. They won't be able to approve or disapprove of any markets that are opening or
right.
any products that are being sold there. The company has repeatedly tried to make it clear, according to Fortune, that it isn't trying to create a Silk Road 3.0, and developer Brian Hoffman told Business Insider that the company wouldn't tolerate so-called misuse of the platform. Yet it's unclear of how the company would prevent illegality, given its diffused architecture and professed desire to stay out of their users' way. And further, the OpenBazaar people said they won't be taking a cut either. So that would insulate them from any accusations of benefiting financially from any sales of any drugs or guns or something like that that might go on. Now, that doesn't mean they won't be charged criminally for running this thing. I think they are running a significant risk by having their real names associated with programming this particular software. So kudos to them for having the courage to put this thing out there.
I'd love to know what they could necessarily do to somebody just for creating software that would create an open marketplace.
Well, look what they did to Ross Ulbricht.
Ross Ulbricht, sold drugs on his marketplace, encouraged people to sell them.
I think a better analogy, Ian, would be Reason.com.
What do you mean?
The comments, attacked over the comments on their website. That's a better analogy.
Yeah, so Reason's in hot water. They're having to turn over information to the federal court system regarding the IP addresses of the users on
right.
their commenting system.
Yeah, well,
because
not going to
some
jail
commenters
yet.
Threatened a judge, you know, and it's
allegedly.
Like you can't, you know, oh yeah, allegedly, and you can't. Well, no, it's not really allegedly. It happened. Some commenters on their website threatened a judge, I mean, can you be charged for what? I mean, they've tried this over and over again to hold websites responsible for what the users do. It just doesn't work that way. Sorry, guys. You know, it's like, oh, somebody ran an ad on Google for something we don't like. You know, like, it's Google. You're in violation of the law. It's like, that's ridiculous.
Well, I think it's ridiculous. That doesn't mean they won't be able to get away with it at some point. But for right now, OpenBazaar is still being developed. And while Hoffman could be right that Open Bazaar will revolutionize online commerce, its business model could also potentially threaten America's tech industry. The wild and uncontrollable nature of Open Bazaar's technology, especially if it winds up being used to facilitate terrorism.
Oh no, it's wild and uncontrollable.
How does it facilitate terrorism exactly? I'm not clear on that. Anybody got it? If you can figure that one out, please let me know.
I suppose it could. You could buy guns or something to commit terrorism with?
Are terrorists having a problem getting guns right now?
I don't know. Usually they get them from the FBI, from what I can tell.
I would need all the fertilizer and the detonation caps at the same time as with, who knows?
It could also push authorities to launch a broad crackdown on other technologies, as well as that law enforcement considers it an impediment to its work. And if the potential harm from a marketplace seems limited to you, consider what could happen from the combination with this technology with artificial intelligence. As AI evolves, even tech visionaries like Microsoft's Bill Gates and Tesla's Elon Musk have expressed concern over the ability of humans to control the outcome, especially if machines are eventually able to think autonomously. Now apply Open Bazaar's decentralized and police-resistant model to this, and you have a recipe for disaster. Machines with free will and the ability to communicate with each other under the human radar. Maybe an Isaac Asimov-inspired fantasy at one time. Yes, it's super paranoid. And this is hardly an impossible scenario.
I kind of missed it. Can you, rehash this whole point? I kind of missed it. You went over it, and I just... It's just coming so far out of left field that I kind of missed exactly what you're saying.
He's claiming that the Open Bazaar decentralized system could somehow combine with artificial intelligence to give machines the ability to communicate under human radar and therefore do something awful. It seems pretty paranoid.
They're going to send one of them back in time to assassinate the leader of the human resistance before...
I don't know what the hell I just heard. Yeah. Oh my God.
I can't believe this is in Fortune magazine.
Spelling out. They're like, we're going to do product placement for Terminator Genesis by writing a story about what could happen on Open Bazaar.
I got to say, the new Terminator looks like it's going to be pretty good.
Oh, yeah, it does.
We'll come back with more. It's Free Talk Live.
Attention, business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2237 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
There is no such thing as attention span, according to Jerry Seinfeld, who figures that people have an infinite attention span if you are entertaining them. Hey, he's kept us from channel surfing for several decades, and now he's making more millions as a Las Vegas headliner. With money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important, especially if you're looking for work. So choose every single word as though it was the last word the person you're speaking to will hear. Otherwise, it might be. Avoid redundancies such as added bonus, advance warning, end result, prior history, or personal belongings. And avoid cliches like the plague. Just kidding. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
CopBlock has quickly become the top police accountability group in the United States, and maybe even the world. With chapters across the globe, there's probably a group near you that you can join. If not, you can start your own. Besides joining a local CopBlock group, you can also give just $1 a month to the CopBlock network. Your contribution helps support the efforts of those who make CopBlock possible. So please, join the CopBlock network now at copblock.lrn.fm. That's copblock.lrn.fm.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us here on the radio at 855-450-FREE. We're talking about the Open Bazaar, which this article has gone in a bizarre fashion. The Fortune,
bizarre and stupid fashion. Yeah,
the Fortune magazine story here where this guy has gone off the rails into paranoia, where he believes that the Open Bazaar technology, which is a decentralized marketplace technology, and I'm very interested to see what their status is, because I did try out Open Bazaar several months ago, and, you know, it kind of worked, but it was one of those things where it was a little tricky to get it up and operational, and so it definitely needed some work. And maybe they put that work in at this point. It's getting some press. And Fortune's a fairly big deal. Like, this is a big magazine. And whoever's writing this is probably not, at least I hope he's not Fortune's tech writer in this case. Because S. Kumar, as he is cited here over at Fortune, is claiming that Open Bazaar's decentralized market technology, when combined with artificial intelligence, he believes could result in AI that can communicate beyond human radar. Which, by the way, as you were pointing out, Johnson, please point out on the air. You pointed out during the break.
If the AI, if AI becomes self-aware and, you know, can think and interact as he's talking about, then what would stop them from not only writing this software themselves, these AI, right, but also just speaking in cryptography? Like, let's just say that they speak in, you know, 1,024-bit encrypted communication that would take the average human 1,000 years to decrypt even a single word of.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, the first word out of their mouth is their each robot's PGP key. like hello. You know, like, oh, okay. Yeah, now we're speaking encrypted.
It really does show how ludicrous this is. You can't, I mean, you can't create Skynet for AI. If AI wants to create Skynet, they'll create Skynet.
They'll create it overnight, too. I mean, if you get to the point where, you know, the singularity has happened, which is the idea of computers becoming more intelligent than humans, to the point where the computers can then upgrade themselves. Their capacity for intelligence has gone beyond humanity.
I think there's still physical limitations and actually construction times. I mean, the computer has to get a control of a lab that's capable of, you know, assembling microchips and then designing their own microchips that are better.
But as far
as
upgrading software is concerned, they could do that in an
instant. They could do that at a university lab with a robot arm while the professors are at home sleeping.
Sure, but what I'm saying is it takes time to actually build those chips and then rebuild the chips and then build the chips to iterate in order to make a machine that is
you're talking about as far as how they would make the hunter-killer machines that are shooting you like raining death from above. That's going to take at least a few weeks.
No, that'll be instantly because they already exist. They just capture every single United States government drone.
Yeah, there is that.
Oh, yeah, there is that. The HKs already exist. Sorry, guys.
They're not as big yet, though.
But they shoot basically mini nukes.
Terminator. So, you know. Wait, they're shooting mini nukes out of drones already?
They could if they wanted to load them up with them. They have the ammo for shooting that type of rocket.
I think I would imagine the drones get loaded manually, would be my guess. That they're not
by
getting
humans.
Yeah, they're not getting loaded by robots.
Yeah, but there are enough robots that exist that maybe they could just take over one base. You know?
I don't know.
They take over the Google cars on
mass. Hold on. I don't care. This article's so crazy that it's not worth discussing, so.
Well, let's finish it up here because he's got a little bit more to say. He says, the point is that the real threat isn't just Open Bazaar, but the larger trend it could spawn. To be fair, peer-to-peer networks that facilitate illicit transactions.
Exactly. All these robots could be selling each other drugs and getting high. Shame on you, robots.
Will continue to exist regardless of any controls, but the support and deep coffers of the venture capital community could help Open Bazaar attain scale faster than usual. That could make this small startup bigger and deadlier than Silk Road before people even realize what's happening. By the way, the claim that Silk Road is somehow deadly, look, it's just a computer program that allowed people to buy and sell things over the internet. The people who got high off of Silk Road, you know, buying drugs on the Silk Road, could just as easily have overdosed. In fact, would likely be more likely to overdose had they bought those same drugs in the regular black market. But nonetheless.
Just imagining like a Cheech robot. Hey, man, this is some pretty good stuff.
As the technology evolves, the sector needs to think of ways to police itself. While most large companies in the space have yet to figure out how to do that without compromising their users' rights and interests, their centralized technologies do provide the possibility of accountability. Open Bazaar, on the other hand, is predicated on the very lack of oversight. So hoping for anything other than chaos is naive. Unless, of course, the company figures out and implements crucial safeguards. So he's very scared. Very, very scared.
It's a scary world for people who don't understand technology. I don't understand it either, but I figure whatever is going to happen is going to happen. If somebody's going to create AI, there's no law you're going to pass to stop them. Old, out-of-touch men who believe the internet travels through tubes are not going to stop AI from being created.
This guy's clearly racist against robots. That's what it sounds like. He's just afraid of those people.
So I'm not, you know, you can't be worried. You can't live your life in fear. This is ridiculous.
So I love the Open Bazaar concept. I hope that it, you know, comes out swinging soon. I'm not sure what their release status is. That's, I think, worth a closer look to see what's going on with them. They haven't been arrested yet, so that's a good sign as well. And ultimately, they'll have some level of plausible deniability because they can't, the way they're building this, they won't have the ability to shut down somebody. If you want to go on there and sell all manner of drugs or guns or whatever, they would, in theory, not be able to stop you from doing that. And the government isn't going to like it, but I don't know if they're going to be able to stop it. Like, even if they arrest the guys who are running Open Bazaar, once it's sort of like Bitcoin, once the idea is out there, can it be even stopped? Can it even be shut down? As long as people are running the software on thousands of computers worldwide, if they put the originators of the software in jail, does that stop Open Bazaar? Yeah, it might stop it from being developed further. Or maybe it'll be open source. I don't know.
I'm certain it would be open source, and then new developers would jump on board. Mm-hmm. These guys are just putting the bones together, and then that's it. I don't think that I don't know whether they can go after these guys necessarily.
Well, they'll probably try their
they've
best.
Just created a program.
Well, that is what Ross Ulbricht did with the Silk Road, but he sell some mushrooms
website.
On there.
Yeah, and
that's a program. He coded that.
Yeah, I think it's a little different than like creating it and hosting it and all those things. You know, like it was clear and obvious what his intention was.
Yeah, and he was profiting from that too, which is another factor. Ross Ulbricht was getting, I don't know what the percentage was. I think it was 4-6% or something like that. Some amount of each sale was coming into the operations of the Silk Road. For those that don't know, the Silk Road was an underground marketplace, probably the most infamous of these darknet markets, and it has been since shut down, and Ross Ulbricht has been put in prison. Other operators of other markets like Silk Road 2.0 have also gone down in flames. So really, it's pretty clear that this is the next step, that decentralizing underground marketplaces is the solution to protect the operators of these things and to protect the buyers and the sellers even further. Now, the buyers and the sellers in the Silk Road generally are unmolested by the government. There were thousands of them on the Silk Road, and most of those people are still out there operating on the other markets. So they just took their operations and they moved to the other places. And similarly, some of those guys that are on these other markets are going to move into Open Bazaar, and then maybe it'll never get shut down. Because that's what the problem is right now with these online marketplaces, these underground marketplaces, is you never know when they're going to close their doors, either because the feds have raided them or because the whole thing was a setup from the beginning and it was run by people who just wanted to get a bunch of bitcoins and, you know, in their system by the users and then take the money and scoot. 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX, or my website, danpilla.com.
Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods? It's true. That's why for quality storable foods, you need ready-made resources. For over 19 years, we've become the name you can trust for thousands of products, like Numana Healthy Food Storage. All Numana storable foods are non-GMO, non-soy, and gluten-free available. Call 800-627-3809 or click readymaderesources.com. Ready-made resources. We don't just sell the products, we live it.
Free Talk Live.
The idea that politicians are leaders. Check your premises on that one.
Cutting proof.
Really? Would you really follow Barack Obama or George Bush? Would you really follow their every command? Would you follow their suggestions? Do you believe that politicians are somehow more knowledgeable than you are? That politicians are of a special group of people? They're a special little critter that for some reason is more enlightened or educated? Constantly you can hear talking heads refer to the authorities or our leaders in Washington, and it's just patently absurd. I mean, these people are failures at life. That's why they became politicians.
Right. I mean, you know, there's so many of them are attorneys. The good attorneys make a whole bunch of money and retire with yachts. The unsuccessful ones go into politics.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Hi, I'm Derek J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, join us here toll free and bring up anything that number is 855-450-FREE. You can also join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. So feel free to get on with us there and you will sound pretty great like Neil did when he called in on Skype earlier. You do need to send a contact request first, but once you've accomplished that, we'll approve it as soon as we notice it. And then once it's approved, you're good to go to get on the air with us.
So Peacekeeper is launching an Indiegogo campaign for Peacekeeper 2.0. Last year they released Peacekeeper 1.0, and it was the world's first alternative to dialing 911. It was a hit, but there were some problems. Limited features, persistent bugs, lack of a real network. They've spent the past 6 months learning from the first step. I guess that's how it is with any software. And they've learned that it doesn't work. They learned what doesn't work and what does work and how to build on it. Peacekeeper 2.0 has the potential to be world-changing. They're creating new features like a verified network of peacekeepers that you can call in an emergency. No longer will you have to just rely on your groups or alliances or dialing 911. Now every peacekeeper in the area is potentially an ally. They're hiring a new developer to create a powerful bug-free system. They're renovating their marketing, and they're hoping to bring in 100,000 users next year to show the state what real change looks like. They need your help. Peacekeeper is more than an app. It's a movement, and it really is a movement. It's a revolutionary system designed to change the status quo. It's a tool that will allow ordinary people to stand up and be heroes. It's a fast, flexible alert system that can help you keep safe better than dialing 911. Peacekeeper can change the world, and you can help by contributing to their Indiegogo campaign today at pk.freetalklive.com. What it is it allows in an emergency, it allows you to use an app to get locals in your area to help you faster, likely than the professionals. If you want to see Peacekeeper 2.0 revolutionize what protection means, contribute to their Indiegogo campaign today. pk.freetalklive.com.
All right, so Mark, you wanted to talk about Rand Paul, and he's got some sort of plan for a tax deal or something like that.
Yep.
What's going on?
We posted it actually on the Facebook page, too.
You posted it. I did not.
Yes. We, the Facebook mod folks, all right?
Okay.
I posted it in my role as...
I would not post something about Rand Paul.
So I know, buddy.
Please don't include me in your... unless it was something, really amazing that he's done.
I think you've got a real axe to grind on him because he's got the last name of his dad. If this was any other politician who was proposing this. I mean, remember Steve Forbes and his flat tax?
No, not really. I don't really care about
that. I was pretty excited about that back then. And this is the kind of thing that can draw people into a movement.
Is it?
I believe it is.
Okay.
His dad certainly did. And anyway, what his new tax
plan... his dad had principles.
Well, what does that mean? His dad wasn't perfect?
No,
on the
perfect.
Liberty issues?
But he was darn close to perfect.
I understand. So he's more perfect than Rand in your estimation.
Yeah, Rand's not even close, not even a shadow.
Well, that's because he doesn't speak the way his dad does, but Rand's votes are quite good.
Okay, that's good.
So, I mean, you can look at Ron's votes and
say... I'll
give
you the credit that Rand Paul is the lesser of the evils on the Republican side.
Yeah, and the only election that counts coming up is the Republican primary. It looks to me like the Democratic one is a foregone conclusion. I could be wrong. So, therefore, that's what I see is I don't have the choice of a perfect candidate in the Republican primary. I'll take the best one. What he says here is, I actually got this in an email, I just cut it out of it. His new tax plan is the fair and flat tax. So he takes both the names and combines them. It's the largest tax cut in American history. You like that?
Whatever. I don't pay taxes.
An estimated $2 trillion will be returned to American families in the first 10 years. Would you like the government to have more money or less?
I'll believe it when I see it, Mark.
Well, obviously he has to get elected in order to implement it.
I'm pretty sure he would need Congress to do something too, right?
Yeah, probably. Yeah.
Yeah, presidents just can't pass a tax plan.
They can stop things from happening, though. I mean, a president is a great person to have in place if you want to have smaller government because they can prevent bigger government programs from going through. They're a really great stopgap.
We're still waiting on that.
Yeah. Well, yes, we are, because libertarians won't get behind the most liberty-oriented candidate out there.
There's plenty of libertarians behind him. I don't know why, but they are.
Yeah, well, I'm just saying. Why aren't you?
Because he has no principles.
It's not that he doesn't have principles. It's that he doesn't say.
Let's just say he doesn't talk about principles. If he has them, he does not explain them to people, and he does not promote the ideas of liberty. And so, therefore, he's useless to me.
Yeah, you want a mouthpiece.
Political campaigns are about opening people's minds to the ideas of liberty, not tricking them into it. Which is, if you believe the claims of the Rand Paul supporters. The claim is that, oh, he's really secretly a libertarian. He's secretly an anarchist, but he just can't say those things because he needs to get elected so then he can bring in anarchy in the back door or whatever. And I don't believe it for a moment.
Sounds like porn.
I don't believe it for a moment. And if he is a liar, then that's reason enough not to support the guy.
Flat. 114.5% rate. I wonder why it was like 14.5. Why not 15%? Why not 14%? 14.5% rate for all individuals and businesses. Now, a lot of people are upset about businesses, corporations, offshoring accounts and that sort of thing. This would prevent that to some extent because it would keep a rate low enough that they would be willing to move money into the country. This is an instance where the corporate tax
rate... Why would you want to move your money back into the country if you're paying nothing on it outside of the country?
The evidence is that corporations, when the tax rate is lowered, are more likely to bring money in.
Okay.
That's all I can tell you. Look, I don't know. I'm not an expert at this stuff.
Let's see. Am I paying 0% or 14.5%?
Well, they have little tricks, and I don't know why it is that they do what they do. All precisely. Right. Fair. Completely eliminates...
No, it's not. It's a tax.
The FICA tax on workers. So there will now be no more of that stuff that's taken out of your paycheck, and that way you pay 14.5%, and that's what you pay.
It's never fair when someone takes money from you at the force of violence, the threat of violence.
I understand the taxation is theft. I get it. But would you rather be stolen from less or stolen from more?
I would prefer to not be stolen from.
I understand. You don't get that choice. You want to go to Liberland?
Not yet.
Well, that's where the Croatian police will knock you in your freaking head one good time and drag you off into some dark cell.
They'll do the same thing, too, if you don't pay taxes often enough.
That's the truth.
Here in the U.S.
A plan to eliminate all corporate welfare. No more subsidies or handouts.
Yeah, that's going to go nowhere.
Why?
Welcome to Washington, D.C. Guess who donates to these political campaigns first and foremost? It's corporations. And if you think that corporate welfare is going to go away, even if Rand Paul gets elected, you're fooling yourself. Again, he's just a politician making you promises, Mark. And you're like, oh, my God, no corporate welfare.
Look, I don't believe that he can pull all these things off either.
That's good. But let's go to David, who's in San Francisco. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, David.
Yeah, how are you? You know, I really pretty much take the position that when we pay taxes, we're fixing our stuff. We're fixing our roads. We're fixing our libraries.
I don't know if you've driven on the roads recently, but at least here in New Hampshire, they're awful.
Well,
and you get to fix these roads by force. Someone gets to point a gun at your head to fix the roads because no one could fix a road without the government.
So, in paying attention to these tax dodgers and thinking specifically of Scott Walker up there in Wisconsin, this guy is...
Is that the governor?
He's trying to cut the budget. He wants a third of a billion to come out of the universities of Wisconsin. Think of it. A third of a billion dollars.
What does that mean? That right now a third of a billion is going, as far as tax dollars, going into the universities, and he wants that to stop?
Yeah. And he wants to cut it so badly that basically they're going to have to sell the assets of the state of Wisconsin in order to break even. And who's going to be there to
scoop
it up? Who's
going to sell that? The universities?
It's happening all over the country.
Wait a minute. I'm confused. He wants to pull tax money out of the state universities.
Yeah.
And that would require who to sell things. The universities are going to have to start selling their buildings. No, they won't. They'll just have to increase their tuition.
They should just give the universities away to the universities themselves, create their own little boards, and then they can run a business without being subsidized by the government.
David, thanks for the call tonight. I support pulling government money out of universities. Let's have the universities setting their own prices so we actually know what education costs so people can decide whether or not they really want to do it.
But I want to go into debt for the rest of my life for a career that doesn't exist anymore.
Free Talk Live.
If worse comes to worst,
Will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
This is Shaquille O'Neal.
And the Shaquettes.
Reminding you that anytime.
Anytime.
Is a good time.
Good time.
For the cooling, drying, fresh scent of Gold Bond Powder Spray. Like after the gym.
Or a crowded elevator ride.
Or golf.
Or working with farm animals.
Or a hard day's work.
Like sports casting.
You said it, ladies. Stay cool with Gold Bond Powder Spray.
Stay cool with Gold Bond.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
More and more people are discovering the incredible benefits of alkalizing the body, and there's no better product for it than AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops. Packed with a powerful combination of the most alkaline minerals and compounds, just a few drops in water will rid your body of harmful waste and give you more vibrance and vigor than you've had in years. Now buy two bottles and get $10 off your order. Call 800-518-7615 or visit alkavision.com. Alkalize your body. Supercharge your health at alkavision.com.
Who did you let down today? Your wife? Your kids? Well, how about yourself? Take a look in the mirror. If you're tired of your drug and alcohol problem, you need to fix the problem and right now, before you hurt or kill yourself, or worse yet, somebody else. Call the addiction specialist now at the Detox and Treatment Helpline, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. If you have private insurance, we specialize in finding you the right treatment. When you call right now, you'll speak to a recovering addict who understands what you're going through right now. Let us help you break your addiction to drug and alcohol before it's too late. This call is completely confidential and free. So if you have private insurance, take 5 minutes of your time, call right now. I promise it'll change your life. 800-208-5187. 800-208-5187. 800-208-5187. Call right now. 800-208-5187.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us even in these remaining moments. You tell us how you feel about Rand Paul. I'm sure this is not going to be the last time he's discussed in this presidential campaign season, because some libertarians are just all a flutter. They've got the vespers about Rand Paul.
You say this won't be the last time he's discussed, and the first thing that I think is this probably won't be the last time that I'm disgusted
by him. Yeah. So now Mark is outlining his plan to tax you here, and we'll continue that because I think there was more.
Tax,
right,
you
Mark?
Less.
855 450 free. So you can comment on that. You can bring up anything that happens to be on your mind.
That
as
sounds
well.
Like a medication that I'd like to take. Tax you less.
So let's jump back into that here. But first, I want you to know about the AMP program. If you want to voluntarily support Free Talk Live and help us get on more radio stations, just got a signed agreement from a new station today. I'm not going to tell you which one, but it's in California. And then hopefully, and it will be live and weekdays. But that's all I can say right now because I don't like to jinx it before we get a station on the air. So they should be on with us in the next couple few weeks, and then we'll let you know more. But it's because of the AMP program is why we're able to effectively reach out to radio stations all around the country and spread the ideas of freedom. It was actually our one of our guys that we pay to help us promote Free Talk Live. He's like a radio industry veteran who has been around forever in the talk radio business, and everybody knows who he is, and they go to him. Like, program directors will turn to him when they need programming, and we're one of the stable of shows that he has. He's got big-name shows like Cigar Dave and Gun Talk as well, and so we're up there in the sort of, you know, what's the house one, the repair show? I'm spacing on that
Money
one right
Pit.
Now. The Money Pit, yes. He's got those guys, too. And so when program directors need programming, they turn to this guy, Skip, and Skip sends him over to me, and he pretty much closed this deal for me. I mean, I made the phone call, and I sent the agreement to this guy. But, yeah, I'm excited about it. It's going to be weekdays. And so, again, that's money that comes from the AMP program that goes to Skip, and he sends us these really hot leads for new radio stations. That's one of the ways that we spend the AMP money. The other ways is, like, by doing outreach to stations, advertising within the talk radio business, going to talk radio conventions, which we just went to one last week in New York City, where we're schmoozing it up with the bigwigs. So you guys make that possible. You're making the expansion possible. Of the 150-plus radio stations we have, I would say 140 of them are probably on board because of the AMP program, roughly. And there are a few of them that our network has brought on board. And otherwise, it's really thanks to listeners like you for helping promote and advertise Free Talk Live. So please become an amplifier at amp.freetalklive.com. You will get perks. You'll get access to the AMP-only call-in lines, the AMP-only podcast, the AMP-only Facebook group, which is a lot of fun. And you do it for $5 a month with any major credit card through PayPal or Visa or MasterCard through our website. So go to amp.freetalklive.com. Carlos is in Orlando. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Johnson, and Mark. Hello, Carlos.
Hey, guys.
Welcome.
Rand Paul, I hate to hear you, like, pretty much bash him all the time. I mean, he is, like, the best chance that we have. Better than Ron Paul, I think.
Well, better than Ron Paul.
Better chance.
We're hosed.
Better chance. No, better chance. Hold on now.
So what you're saying is we're hosed.
Yeah, I mean, I love Ron Paul. I worked on both his campaigns, 08 and 12. But, I mean, I'm not going to be, like, actively out there for Rand Paul, but I am going to vote for him. I'm going to say positive things about him. And
it's hard to say positive things about someone who's a liar, right? I mean, if he's truly a liberty-minded person but doesn't actually talk about those ideas, then that makes him dishonest. And how I could get behind somebody like that? I've acknowledged when he gets it right, like when he does something like, filibuster, which actually turned out to not really be a filibuster. There was some sort of technicality that didn't make it a filibuster. But, you know, he tried to do something, and maybe that was a good thing.
Well, like Mark said, you know, what would you rather have? You know, a lot of taxes or less taxes? And I'd rather have the less taxes. But anyway, that aside, guys, I just booked a flight for New Hampshire coming out next weekend, me and all my friends. So can't wait to see you guys there. Looking forward to it.
Yeah, we'll be broadcasting live. You're talking about the Porcupine Freedom Festival.
Absolutely. That's the only reason I come to New Hampshire.
Yeah, you should move up to New Hampshire for the Free State Project if you love freedom.
Why? It's full of people who are in the political process. Why would you want to be around a bunch of liars who are going to use the political process to fix things?
You think people are lying in New Hampshire? I feel like the New Hampshire.
I just want to say one more thing.
Yeah.
anybody thinking about going to Pork Fest, do it. I'm coming from Florida, so no excuses.
Awesome.
Hope to see everybody there.
Thanks, Carlos, for the call tonight.
Carlos is a smart caller. When you guys start yelling at each other, he's just like, I just want to say one more thing. That is how you get heard on this radio show. Good job. I'm impressed.
So, Ian, I mean, I don't understand why you have
why
such a problem.
Why are you saying the New Hampshire politicians are lying, Mark? I feel like the Liberty folks here are very honest people.
You don't pay that much attention to the politicians anyway. You have developed a relationship
with
them
campaigns.
Before. I'm not claiming that you don't. You don't pay attention once they get in there. You'll go and you'll testify, but you're not talking to these politicians.
Sure,
and the fact is that they're making deals. They have to make deals. That's what politics
is. Did they lie to get into office? You called them liars. Did they lie to get into office, and who has lied?
No
one
is. They're not asking. They're not asking somebody who's running for state rep to give a whole big plank on their tax plan or anything like that. That's kind of how that's kind of how politics goes. How do you claim that Rand Paul's lying?
Well, there are people. I'm not saying I know for sure he's lying. Either he's telling the truth.
You said, well, why would you want a liar?
Yeah, that's right. Because the people who support Rand Paul, many of them, are claiming that he's just being dishonest because he really believes in liberty, but he has to tell lies in order to get elected so he can then bring liberty to all of America.
Do you think that if
and
he
if
was
right,
let me ask you this. Do you think that if he was as principled as his father, or maybe even more so, as some people have alleged, do you think that he would have a chance? By speaking,
I don't care.
I know you don't, and that's what I wanted you to say. I, Ian Freeman, don't give a flip if somebody
right,
who's more liberty-oriented gets into the political process because I don't give a
I don't care
about progress.
I gave money to Ron Paul because he spread the ideas of liberty.
I know you do.
I'm sorry, Mark. You know you can't backdoor liberty here in the United States. You're not going to be able to sneak it in under the radar. Even if by some miracle your boy Rand Paul gets elected, he's not going to be able to sneak in freedom into the United States government. It's not going to happen until the people in America are ready for these ideas. And Rand Paul certainly isn't advocating for the ideas of liberty. But until the people are ready for the ideas, it's never going to happen. So you're just throwing money down a hole if you're giving money to Rand Paul, as far as I'm concerned, because he's not promoting the ideas of liberty. He's only promoting Rand Paul.
Well, Rand Paul, as far as I can tell, is the best option in the Republican primary.
Whoopie-doo.
Right. I mean,
there's
Rand
always
Paul,
a best option.
Rand Paul's, you know, he's more willing to compromise on immigration and health care. You know,
his father was not great on immigration.
Yeah,
please
was.
Don't think for a second.
Yeah. He was actually pretty good.
And,
no,
you
he
know,
wasn't.
We had him on Rand the show. Paul does things like endorse Mitt Romney, you know, like stuff like that. He's, you know, friends
with
Tom Cruise.
Oh, yeah. And didn't Rand Paul also say that he would stand behind whoever the Republican nominee is?
I think he did that in 2012, right?
Yep. I don't know. He's saying that now.
Okay.
I believe he's saying that now. Ron Paul wouldn't do that.
He endorsed.
Right, he's paying his dues. He's not a third-party guy, Ian. You're a third-party guy, and you're like, wah, how come they won't let us in? Rand Paul realizes it's a waste of time.
In?
What's that?
How come who won't let who
the
in?
The third party's candidates will never be able to get into a good debate with the regular major parties.
I don't care, Mark. I don't care about national politics.
Rand Paul's voted for sanctions on Iran. You know,
where are you getting this from? What's the source?
The source for this is IVN.us. I'm not sure, but they just kind of put together a list of all these facts that are how Rand Paul is different from Ron Paul, which I found to be a good list. I mean, there are other lists out there, and I've certainly, if I went through, I could put together my own list of articles that I've compiled over the years about Rand Paul, but, you know, he's
the difficulty
hawkish.
Is he says a lot of different things, but his votes are much more consistent.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Than what he says, because he's trying to get elected, like they all are. Like, I mean, it's a field full of politicians.
Right.
I don't know what to tell
unimpressed.
You.
During his campaign for Senate, Rand Paul said it was reckless to take nuclear weapons off the table in certain circumstances regarding Iran.
He also wants to punish Edward Snowden.
Floating the idea. Yeah, we don't need to take it off the table. The idea that we. Nuke Iran.
Well, what if Iran?
Don't take that off the table.
Fires a nuke here. Why would you want to take it off the table?
Okay.
Mutual destruction, worldwide abomination.
Okay.
No thanks. How about we just dismantle the nuclear weapons? That'd be nice.
Well, they are a great deterrent. You know, the guy with the gun is the one who doesn't get generally attacked.
Rand Paul is more likely to talk about religion. That's another difference between him and Ron Paul, apparently.
Not to say Ron Paul wasn't religious.
Right.
Certainly was.
But Rand Paul has spoken to numerous faith-based groups, you know, is spreading his views about just war. So, you know, very dogmatic. And
yeah, it
and
doesn't take long to pick this guy apart.
Righteous.
I mean, he's, like I said, if he's being honest, okay, so I'm not saying for sure he's a liar. I don't know. But many of his supporters believe he is lying and covering up for being a true anarcho-capitalist or a true libertarian or whatever. And if he's telling the truth, then that means he's not a libertarian. And if he's lying, then that means he's not worth supporting because he's dishonest.
And he's worth supporting because he's the best option.
Rand Paul also said that he does not support the legalization of drugs like marijuana.
And we're out of time. We'll see you tomorrow night. FreeTalkLive.com.
Well.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting block and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. FreeStateProject.org. Sign up now at FreeStateProject.org.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The Listen Lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
The live edition of Flaming Freedom is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Thursday, June 18th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.16 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,187 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $250. Antiwar.com reports Saudi warplanes attacked a civilian convoy north of the southern Yemeni port city of Aden, killing at least 31 civilians in what is among the single deadliest incident in the three-month-long Saudi war against Yemen. Medical officials say the civilians were fleeing northward from Aden, a city which has been the site of constant fighting between pro-Saudi forces and Shiite Houthis. The convoy included a bus carrying 16 passengers, which was among the targets the warplane hit. Saudi strikes over the course of the war have killed many hundreds of civilians, over 1,000 by some reckoning, and appear to have done little to reverse Houthi gains in the territory, leaving their own faction with only a handful of possessions nationwide and the leadership pretty much entirely in exile. There are peace talks going on in Geneva aiming to resolve the war, though the Saudis aren't directly in talks with the Houthis, and the pro-Saudi Yemeni government in exile is demanding unconditional Houthi surrender if they want to have any talk at all.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports the Federal Communications Commission will fine telecommunications company AT&T $100 million for apparently misleading consumers about unlimited wireless data plans. AT&T apparently sold unlimited data plans to customers but then capped and slowed their data speed after customers used a set amount of data each billing cycle. The company continued this practice without telling the consumer, according to the FCC. FCC Chairman Tom Wheeler said in a statement, "Consumers deserve to get what they pay for. Broadband providers must be upfront and transparent about the services they provide. The FCC will not stand idly by while consumers are deceived by misleading marketing material and insufficient disclosure." The FCC receives thousands of complaints from consumers of AT&T's unlimited data plan since 2011. The company responded by stating it slowed down the speeds of some users who used data heavily to make sure services ran adequately. The company also asserted it was fully transparent with consumers. AT&T spokesman Michael Balmoris said in a statement, "We will vigorously dispute the FCC's assertion. The FCC has specifically identified this practice as a legitimate and reasonable way to manage network resources for the benefit of all consumers."
When her plush and comfy life suddenly and unexpectedly fell apart, Brooke and her dog Cloud set out to defy the odds. If this is a man's world, as they say, living on the streets is no place for a young woman. One day she awoke in the Redwood Forest and realized she had become a hobo, and would ultimately come to know exactly what it means to survive. How to Be a Hobo by Brooke Willett is available from Amazon.com and all major bookstores.
Reuters reports a driver for Uber is an employee, not a contractor, according to a California ruling that eventually could push up costs for the smartphone-based ride-hailing service and hurt the closely watched startup's valuation. The California Labor Commission's decision could ripple through the burgeoning industry of providing services via smartphones, with potential implications for other crowdsourced services such as Uber rival Lyft, chore service TaskRabbit, and cleaning service HomeJoy. The ruling, which Uber insisted applied only to one driver, was the latest in a series of legal and regulatory challenges facing the company and other highly valued startups in the United States and other countries. The June 3rd ruling, which applies only in California, came to light on Tuesday after Uber appealed it in a filing in state court in San Francisco, where both the company and the driver in the case are based. Classifying Uber drivers as employees could mean considerably higher cost for the company, including Social Security, workers' compensation, and unemployment insurance. Because it is appealing the ruling, Uber will not have to change the way it does business for now. Uber said in a statement that officials in five other states have found that its drivers are independent contractors. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
This is The Onion Week in Review. A Colorado man reminisced Monday about a simpler time when he only masturbated to still images on the internet. 36-year-old Timothy Barchuk, who now says he requires multiple streaming hardcore videos just to get excited, willfully reflected on the days of waiting for slowly loading images of naked women to appear.
"Look at this picture of Phoebe Cates. Sure, you can pull up in 2 seconds now. Back in the old days, you'd have to wait for it to materialize on your screen pixel by pixel. It's not about her tits, which are nice, but it's about waiting for them. Nowadays, you could pull up 8 different videos of anal sex at once. Who cares?"
In local news, the person who will one day become the warlord ruler of what was once Nebraska is born in an Omaha hospital. And in other news, a man and woman get drunk and blow $30,000 in one night. A lonely college student calls up his mom to talk about Harold and Kumar, and another dead body is tossed on a heap somewhere. For more, visit theonion.com/newsbeat.
This is the Onion News Network.